I know it was a tough row to hold.
Coach Marksberry and his troops are repeating that sentiment tonight. With losses in the first three games of the year to Hart County, Collins, and South Oldham, their garden is full of weeds that they'll have to cultivate carefully over the last seven games. And the task doesn't get any easier tonight as 5A Fairdale Bulldogs come to town and meet Spencer County for the first time in school history. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Taylorsville, Kentucky, on the campus of Spencer County High School. Alongside my partner, John Hutchins, I am Bo Bruner, and we are proud to bring you the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show for week four of Bears football here on GHP Sports. And, John, it's construction night.
Yeah,
it's
I like
neon
that.
Night, whatever. Future Bears night.
Out here,
we got all these Grizzlies and
Stallions
Bears running around
here
tonight.
In the background, yeah. I didn't know if it was construction night or if you were, like, flagging traffic out there to park, you know, sometime between commercial breaks and things like that. I wasn't sure.
Well, I mean, like I said, it's better not dress up on construction night than pajama night.
Yeah, I'm sure our viewers like
we'll just leave it at that.
But really, how about this weather, Bo? I mean, this is great out here tonight. Nice and cool down. We had some rain come through today. But the cooler temperatures really just kind of get you in that feel, get you in that fall type of a thing, you know. You can almost smell the pumpkin spice in the air even right now as we got these players out here. Just a nice, great evening for this atmosphere. And it's great to be back in Taylorsville 2 weeks in a row. Back here, be able to do our set of game day. And it's great to have the people back here behind us, these kids behind us right now. And, so sit back. Enjoy. Come on down. You still got an hour before kickoff if you'd like to come down here. But if not, we got you covered here on GHP Sports. And, we're going to have a great time.
So we are going to step away for just a minute. But when we return, a new guest picker and someone, John, we are here at GHP Sports. We're very happy to introduce him.
We are very happy
to everyone here.
Yep.
And we're about 52 minutes away from kickoff right now on the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show on GHP Sports.
Oh, boy. What? We better get out of here. That clown is about to hit a water line.
He didn't contact 811 to mark the underground utilities.
Nope.
You saw that coming. Too bad he didn't.
Know what's below. 811 before you dig.
The Cooperative Extension Office.
811 before you dig.
The Cooperative Extension Office is here to serve all residents of Spencer County with educational and research-based programs. We offer programs for youth 5 to 18 years old through our 4-H program, where youth can make the best better. We offer free soil testing, and if you love to get your hands dirty, consider becoming a master gardener. We also offer programs for prevention, wellness, and individual family development, or you can check out our homemaker groups. We are located at 100 Oak Tree Way off Highway 44 in Taylorsville, Kentucky. Come in and see us or check us out on our website or Facebook.
Welcome back to Spencer County High School here for the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show. And, John, we are excited to introduce everyone, Brandon Ables.
Yeah.
Brandon, welcome to the show. How you doing, man?
Guys, thank you so much for having me. It's a great privilege and honor to be here, and I'm super excited to be here tonight, and thank you guys for having me.
Yeah, I'm kind of getting a crick in my neck trying to look
up. Well, I asked for a milk crate to stand on, but I didn't get one.
We're kind of being towered over a little bit.
Guys, I have that effect on a lot of people, so you're not alone here.
Brandon is going to be doing the play-by-play for baseball and softball come this spring, so we thought it'd be a good idea to bring him in and introduce him to everybody. And Brandon, John tells me that you went to Fairdale High School. What do you remember about your time there?
Yes, sir. Way to just get right into it. Yeah, I'm a Fairdale boy. Born and raised, lived in Fairdale basically my whole life till we came out here to Spencer County. I went to Fairdale 1 year, had a good year, played basketball for Fairdale. It's a great school, great community. But let's just say I made a good decision 7 years ago. We'll just put it that way.
Yeah, so we know that you're also a very big part, an integral part right now of the Spencer County Middle School basketball program. What kind of team are we looking like this year?
Great question. You know, last year was my first year with the program. I coached the seventh grade team. We went to the conference championship game. Got beaten overtime, unfortunately, but, these kids are growing. They're hungry. We just wrapped up tryouts last night, and I think we got a great group of young men coming into the program, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. I am so ready to get going. This is going to be a great group to coach, and I'm just ready to go. And I hope the community rallies around these kids because they're a great group.
And that's really just to follow up on your answer there. That's the attitude I want from a coach. If I'm a player, if I'm a parent, whoever's involved, somebody to have that positive attitude, that energy that brings that to that basketball court and just helps drive that. That's awesome.
Yeah, man. I mean, what else can you be? You're coaching young people, trying to be a positive influence in their lives. You're trying to get them down here, be ready to be Bears in a few years. So that's the way I look at it, and I'm super excited to be a part of this program. And these kids are fantastic. The parents are fantastic. And we're ready to go. We're ready to get going.
And what a better night. I didn't even think about this till later in the week of how we were having you be able to introduce you to our GHP viewers, but also to be future Bears night and have a middle school coach down here. I thought the timing just
worked out great.
Oh, it did.
It did work out great. I've seen a couple of my guys back here already. I see a couple of the elementary school kids. I mean, it's a rowdy, raucous night down here, so we're ready to go, right?
Well, Brandon, you involved in basketball, but you're going to be doing baseball and softball for us. Do you have a baseball background?
You know, I'm just a huge seam head, right? Like, I never played
I've
baseball.
I've never heard it called that before. That's a first for me.
Really?
Really.
Well, I'm here to educate
there
too,
we go.
John.
There we go. No. My higher education.
Right. I only played baseball 1 year. Basketball was kind of always my sport for obvious reasons, but I have always kept up with baseball. I love baseball. Ever since we moved to this community, I keep up with Bears baseball, so I'm ready to go for that too.
So kind of in line with that baseball type of a background and how much you enjoyed that and being involved with this, you know, you'll be, as Bo mentioned, calling baseball and softball games for GHP Sports this spring. What made you want to be involved with GHP Sports?
Are you kidding me? I mean, look around, right? I mean, this is fantastic. I mean, I've been watching you two since I moved down here, and this has gotten up and going. It's absolutely fantastic. Who would not want to be a part of GHP Sports? So when the opportunity presented itself, why not? Jump on board, right?
Yeah. And then just one more question. And this one pains me a little bit. It really does, because it's not really so much a question for you as it is for Bo, but it's tied to you. So we already know from knowing you where your collegiate allegiance lies. Actually, probably a very happy man last night watching the Louisville Cardinals win their ball game. And being a Cardinal fan, of course, Bo and I are both Wildcats, have the hats on and everything right now. Bo?
Our picking process for guests needs to be a little bit better.
That's what I was about to ask. When are we going to start screening these guests a little bit better? Get some Wildcats up here that kind of go along with it.
Dr. Foster last week was here, and he was a big Cardinal fan. So
you all have good taste. Maybe not in the teams you pick, but the people that you bring on the show with you, you've got good taste. So, I mean.
I don't know how to take that.
Well, now we're going to get to the hard part. John and I pick about three games every week, plus the Spencer County game every week, and kind of go over them and give our picks. And you being our guest here tonight, going to be our celebrity guest picker, if you will, for Spencer County game day. And we're going to start, first I'll say, and I'll give John credit, last week, first week we done this, he was 3-1. Me and Dr. Foster was 1-3.
Wait a minute. Say, I don't think they heard you in the back. What was that?
I was 1-3.
And John was?
3-1.
Thank you. I appreciate that. That's great.
So we're going to start with a game tonight. 2-1 Collins at 2-1 Oldham County. What you got?
Well, let's go Spencer! You know, listening to the kids behind me, I'm a Spencer County guy. I can't vote or pick Collins at all. So give me the Colonels of Oldham County.
Not so fast. These two teams, first of all, they haven't met since 2019. So keep that in mind. A lot of new players out there on the field. And it was a game which Oldham County actually did win. So if we go back in time, I'm with you on that pick. But right now, 2023, can't do it. A lot has changed since then. The Colonels quarterback, Derek Dees, he's 28 of 41 passing so far this season. And then he only has one touchdown. So to be effective and then lose that effectiveness in the red zone has kind of been the Achilles heel for the Colonels this year. On the flip side for the Titans, Lanehart, we got an opportunity to watch him twice, Bo and I did, up for the Shelby County Collins game, but then also to call the game with Collins. Lanehart leading the team with 29 tackles, coupled with the experience of Kate Gooden, give me the Titans.
I'm with you, John. As much as I was a fanboy of Kenyon Gooden, I think his brother may be better, and he's only a freshman. We've seen him play, like you said, a couple games so far this year. And he's also developed a connection with Michael Schramm, who is actually now seventh in the state in receiving yards.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take the Titans by 10.
Wow. Wow.
You're kind of on an island there, Mr. Cardinal.
I am, but that's okay. I like it.
All right.
Now, these next two are probably the two biggest games in the state.
Yeah,
this week.
Pretty rough.
So we'll start with 3-0 Scott County, who's number one in 5A, and they travel to Danville to take on 3-0 Boyle County, which is number one in 4A.
Now, before we have you make your pick, I want everybody to know, Brandon and I, earlier in the week, I was texting him, gave him these games that we were going to pick. And the text message I got back, we're picking those games. So to see what it was, the level of competition in these games, I mean, really, in all honesty, these games are rough to pick. But Mr. Abels, as our guest, you have the honors.
Bull and Scott first, right?
Yes, sir.
Yep. Look, Bull and Scott. Go ahead, get your notes out. Me and John have ours.
On paper, these two teams are evenly matched.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're looking at the KSR rankings, Bull County's coming in number one at the KSR rankings, and then Scott's coming in at number seven. They're both averaging about 46 points a game. Both of them's putting up some yards per game. That being said, just going off my historical knowledge of high school football in this state and what Bull County has always been, always competing for state championships. Scott County, no slouches either. They're always up there as well. But I'm going to take Boyle County in this one.
Good pick. Good pick. Boyle County, a Jabberwocky of a team. And I love using that word, Jabberwocky. I try to work it in every year. But anyway, year in and year out, powerhouse football team in 4A. I mean, it's constant. Of course, we've talked before how Danville used to be Title Town. Then Boyle County got to be. And then speaking of that Danville team, Boyle County coming off a 56-0 win over Danville last Friday night. And the one concern most people would have about that is, more often than not, you play a team like that. You play a crosstown rival like that. Emotions are high. And then to win the game in the manner that they did, you're almost afraid Boyle County is going to have kind of a letdown week that following week, especially when they're going up against a team as good as Scott County. But not this week, not this team. Coach Haddix, he's going to have those boys in check. Boyle County gets their fourth straight win of the season tonight at home.
I can't make up words like John does, even though I am from Eastern Kentucky, and we do talk funny.
You can't spell the ones you do say.
That's well. But you kind of stole my thunder there, Brandon. 46 points a game for both teams. Both teams are only giving up 13 points a game. So two very evenly matched teams. One thing is going to steer my decision. I think Montavon Quisenberry is the best player in the state, even though he's only a junior. So I'm going to take Boyle County by 20.
Wow. Big win. Big win, big win.
Now, next, 2-1 Lexington Christian, number 2 in 2A, comes to Louisville to take on 3-0 Cal, who's number 1 in 3A. This is the battle of the best two quarterbacks in the state.
Yes, by far.
As far as recruiting rankings and stuff like that goes. So, Brandon, who you got here?
Look, this is a tough one. Honestly, I mean, you got Cal putting up 42 points a game. You got Lexington Christian putting up 41 points a game. You got Cal putting up 418 yards a game with 311 passing yards a game. And then Lexington Christian's putting up almost 500 yards a game.
That is hard to do at any level. That's from middle school up to the pros, putting up 500 yards a game is an impressive, impressive number. But going back to what we were talking about earlier, this is Louisville versus Lexington here. I'm taking the Centurions. Give me Cal.
Not so fast. Great research. Great. I love the fact you're pulling the stats out, getting those numbers out and everything. I'll be honest, I've been back and forth 100 times about this game throughout the week, trying to figure out who I wanted to go with, because on one side you got Cutter Bowley with Lexington Christian. On the other side, you got Christian McAdamy with Cole Hodge. Like Bo said, two of the best quarterbacks in the state of Kentucky, at least the most highly recruited quarterbacks. And, you know, even as we make these picks tonight on the Kentucky Call 811 pregame show, I'm still doubt my picks. I still, this one kind of gets me. I'm going to stick with what I have. So far this season, Cutter Bowley at Lexington Christian, 59 of 98 for passing, 6 touchdowns, averaging 302.7 yards a game. The downside, he does have 4 interceptions. So that kind of made it rough on that one. But when you add in running back Brady Hensley's 746 yards, averaging 248.7 yards per game with 10 touchdowns of his own, I mean, that's an offense that's kind of hard to overlook. On the other side, we mentioned Cole Hodge, quarterback out here at Christian Academy, 62 of 86 for 15 touchdowns, averaging 287.7 yards per game through the air. But the problem is he's also the Centurions' leading rusher and only averaging 47 yards a game. You put that one-dimensional offense on the field for Christian Academy against a very stout, two-headed attack from Lexington Catholic. I'm going Lexington Christian.
Lexington Christian, powerful quarterback, Cutter Bowley, UK commit, great on the field. But listen to this schedule, John. Okay, they have played the number 2 team in 5A in Bowling Green, number 1 team in 4A, Boyle County, number 1 team in single A, Pikeville. Tonight they play the number 1 team in 3A in Cal, all before the Holy War, as they dub it, next week against number 4 in 3A, Lexington Catholic.
Yep.
I'm all for playing a tough schedule. That may be a little much. I'm going to take Cal.
I'm going to get another one on you right there, then. That's what it's going to be. We're going to up those stats on my end.
And then our last game, the game here tonight, 1-2 Fairdale at 0-3 Spencer County. Now, Brandon, I'll let you go first.
Bo? John?
Yes, sir.
Ever since I found out about this last week, I've been dreading this. I mean, we got the Fairdale Bulldogs in town against the Spencer County Bears. I'm a Fairdale boy, born and raised, spent my whole life basically in Fairdale. I'm still in Fairdale 2 to 3 nights a week. This is tough. But who am I kidding? I'm going Bears all the way, baby. I left Fairdale for a reason, and we're going to prove that tonight. We're going to get this thing turned around starting tonight against the Fairdale Bulldogs.
Great pick right there. You may have came from Fairdale. You're reformed a little bit. Come
Absolutely.
Out here to Spencer County, reformed. Both these teams, they've kind of underwhelmed so far to start this year. You know, you look at what the teams did last season and how competitive they were. I believe Fairdale knocked out in the third round of the playoffs last year. Spencer County knocked out in the second round of the playoffs last year. Kind of not really the start that either one of those teams did. Like Spencer County on a 3-game skid right now, though. But honestly, I look for Spencer County to get back on track. Defense has really got to stop just a one-headed attack from the rushing game. Go Bears!
Absolutely.
I'm like you. I kind of dreaded this one all week. And I'm not going to lie, no offense to Coach Marksbury and his staff and players. All week I told myself, I hate to do it, but I'm going to take Fairdale. But John comes over to the house every Wednesday night. We watch film of the game coming up. We watch film on Fairdale this past Wednesday night, and I just don't see it. I'm taking Bears. The defense is going to step up.
That's
now,
right.
The offense has to do something on the field. The offense has not scored in over 75 minutes of game time. That will change tonight. Bears defense will shut down the running game. Give me the Bears in a low-scoring game, 14-12.
It's nice. Good picks.
So, Brandon, anyway, congratulate you on becoming part of the GHP Sports family. Appreciate you coming on here. And you got any questions, all you got to do is contact me and John, and we'll tell you what we don't know.
This sounds like a plan.
Yeah,
to me,
and if I don't know the answer, that's when you get the text, new phone, who dis, back from me. So
I get it.
But no, in all seriousness, Bo's right. We are glad to have you on board, and appreciate your commitment to these young kids when it comes to middle school basketball. We appreciate your new commitment now to GHP Sports and what you'll be able to bring to the microphone for baseball and softball this coming spring. And, man, I look forward to a good time.
Guys, I'm looking forward to it immensely, so I can't wait to get started with you guys as well. Thank you for tonight.
Thank you, Brandon. We're going to take another quick break, but when me and John come back, we'll start talking about the Fairdale Bulldogs as we are about 34 minutes away from kickoff on the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show on GHP Sports.
At Acadia Counseling, we offer a professional, down-to-earth approach for adults, families, couples, and adolescents who are looking for lasting results in a non-judgmental environment. Located in St. Matthews and offering telehealth straight to your phone or Wi-Fi-enabled smart device, Acadia Counseling offers evening and weekend appointments. Give us a call or schedule from our website and create a brighter future for yourself or a loved one.
The People's Bank is proud to be a sponsor of the SCHS Bears. The People's Bank is an independent, local community bank dedicated to serving Spencer and surrounding counties. At the People's Bank, we are here to serve you with deposit accounts, mortgage loans, construction and land loans, as well as business and personal loans. The People's Bank is conveniently located with two locations, 23 West Main Street in historic downtown Taylorsville, and a branch at 5511 Taylorsville Road in Fisherville. Or you can visit us at our website, www.tpbtaylorsville.com. Banking excellence since 1903. The People's Bank, an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Not again. You don't mess with underground power lines.
Should have contacted 811. They'll mark those utility lines free.
Yeah, but this guy ain't real bright.
Neither is the neighborhood.
No, watch below 811 before you dig.
Spencer County High School and the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show. John is excited to meet Brandon down there. Well, we've met him before, but
Good to introduce him to the Spencer County fan base.
Yeah, it kind of took my breath away. That or the stairs.
It wasn't talking to Brandon. I think it was the stairs.
Yeah, I think so, too. Hey,
well, we're in the same boat. But Future Bears Night here at Spencer County. And, John, this is one of my favorite times of the year. You get to see the young kids. There's Grizzlies uniforms. There's Stallion uniforms running all over the place here. And the kids get really excited to come over here and get on this high school football field.
And I'm with you. This is one of my favorite games. This is a game I always look forward to. I mean, to see these young players. I mean, these are players we're going to see on Friday nights in a few years out here on this field and be calling their names. You know, all the future Bears out there, I want you to keep that in mind. If you go back, Bo and I can't wait to be able to see you out here on the field. We can't wait to be able to call your name, to give your stats, to call you player the Trevor Brown Construction Player of the Game, yep. And even to yell touchdown Bears for you when you cross that goal line. So stick with it, you know, practice hard, listen to your coaches, and most of all, any of you watching this later on, thank your parents. They're the ones out there that they're running you to practice, they're cheering for you in the stands, making sure you get to the games. Those are your biggest fans. They'll be the biggest ones you ever have. So say thank you to mom and dad.
That's exactly right. John, moving on along with the program, now about 29 minutes away from kickoff, we have to talk about last week.
Oh, goodness.
And Bears lost their home opener, 46-0, John, and South Olden Dragons. Fell to 0-3 on the young season. Two sentences to me sum up the game for the Bears. And they struggled to contain that triple option, especially quarterback Nick Hamilton. And the offense was stagnant. Only managed 106 yards total for the game.
Describing it as stagnant, Bo, that might be too kind. You come from the country. I come from the country. I'm sure many of our viewers out there have heard the saying, you're moving like molasses in winter. And that's kind of how I saw our offense last week. Well, we did have some sparks of hope every once in a while, but, you know, Spencer County, typically year in and year out, a very offensively stout team, and they've just struggled a lot when possessing the football this season. We've seen glimpses of hope, as I mentioned, but, Bo, this ineffective ball movement has to be the biggest concern for Coach Marksberry this week and all the other weeks.
The score was tied at zero, John, with about 9:15 left to go in the second quarter, and Spencer County, or South Oldham actually scored 9:05 left on a quarterback keeper, on the quarterback option by Hamilton. Took it 20 yards for the touchdown, and then it just snowballed after that for the Bears. Next possession, Spencer County went 3-and-out, went to punt. The punt was blocked. South got the ball on the 7-yard line. It did take them 4 plays to score, but on 4th down, Hamilton found far in the corner of the end zone and made the game 12-0 that quick. Spencer County goes back out. They did have the good run by Kellen Marksberry.
They did. They did.
And I think that was a 43-yard gain on one play. That's 43 out of the 106 they had for the complete game. But then they turned the ball over, had a turnover. South goes down, scores. It's 18-0, and it just, like I said, it just snowballed from there.
It did. And, you know, I hate that for the Bears. I hate that for some of the kids out there on the field, you know. But it's one of those that, again, I talked about it last week, that nothing will bring out character like failure will. And so to be able to deal with that, to cope with that, and hopefully work up from that, that's what the Bears really need to try to focus on from this point forward.
In the second half, South steadily moved the ball on the ground. The Bears offense continued to struggle. South went on to a 46-0 victory. They had 333 yards of offense, 258 on the ground, while the Bears only managed 106 yards, 75 rushing, 31 through the air. And like I mentioned, 43 of those was on that one run by Kellen.
Yeah, that's right.
Defensively, there was some bright spots, and despite as ugly as the score was, John, I actually thought the defense played well enough to win. The offense kind of put them in bad position on 3 or 4 possessions.
Yep.
Nick Stowe led the way, had 12 tackles, and Keenan Carnes had 9. Kellen Marksberry had an interception, and they were just put in a bad spot. And between the turnovers and the block punt, it was hard for them to make any hay.
And I agree with you. The defense really did play well. Honestly, the Bears defense, despite what the final score ended up being in that game, and in all the other games. They've played well enough for Spencer County to be 3-0 right now. And what it's boiled down to is just having trouble with this offense. But, you know, the problem that's kind of rearing its ugly head in a lot of these games is that our defense is spending so much time on the field and they're getting tired. You can't expect these boys to spend three quarters of the contest on the field and not lose a step or two in the second half.
We're going to take another break, but when we return on the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show, we'll take a deep dive into this Fairdale Bulldog squad as we are now about 25 minutes away from kickoff here on GHP Sports.
When you look for a veterinarian for your four-legged friends, you want not only the best care, but also someone who loves your pets as much as you do. At Bourbon City Animal Hospital, we know your pets are family. That's why we treat you like you're a part of ours. Find us at 101 Buchanan Boulevard, Suite 1 in historic Bardstown, Kentucky, or on the web at bourboncityanimalhospital.com.
Welcome back to the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show here at Spencer County High School. And, John, let's take a look at these Fairdale Bulldogs. For the second week in a row, Spencer County will be facing a team they've never met before on the football field.
Yep.
Fairdale's coached by Louis Dover. He's in his seventh season at the helm, has a career record of 42-26. He was the head coach at Seneca from 04 to 11, and he's had assistant stints at Seneca, Doss, Ballard, and Central. And interestingly enough, he replaced Matt Wright at Fairdale, who has moved on to coach another Spencer County opponent this year, Henry County.
Yeah, that's right. And credit the Bulldogs' success over these last recent years. I mean, when looking into their seasons past, Bo, it honestly reminds me of the Spencer County Bears and what Spencer County's been able to do and the run they've had in the playoffs. And then you look at this Fairdale team, which I hope everybody throughout this pregame, throughout the entirety of this game, remembers Fairdale's 5A school, Spencer County a 4A school, so a larger school at that. And to be able to come out here with the successes that they've had, and really a lot of Jefferson County schools have kind of struggled as of late. You do have the few, like we mentioned, Christian Academy. We'll talk about Central. We'll talk Mayo. We'll talk some of the, you know, St. X, Trinity, schools like that. But a lot of the just more public schools type in that area, they really struggle. So, you know, great job by Fairdale to do what they have, or to be able to do what they did. But just like Spencer County too, graduation always looms. And Fairdale last season losing a lot of players on their team, just like Spencer County did.
The Bulldogs have won four straight winning seasons under Dover, made it to the third round of the playoffs last year, and also made it in three of those four straight winning seasons, made it to the third round of the playoffs. Last year, they were 11-2. John, they lost their first game to perennial power Beachwood 36-0, and then reeled off 11 wins in a row, only to lose in the third round of the playoffs by that same 36-0 score.
That's right,
to
yeah.
State semifinalist Owensboro, and that was their best year since 2019. Now, as far as the players go for the Bulldogs, John, they returned four starters on both sides of the ball. That was at the beginning of the season. But offensively, senior Jarrell Mason started the season at quarterback, but we actually seen him when we was watching film the other night, John, in week two against Fern Creek, suffered an injury. We don't know the extent of that injury, but since then, Coach Dover has platooned the QB1 position with sophomore James Myers and freshman Jarrell Butler. Those two are combined 4 of 8 for 57 yards and one touchdown.
Yeah, and losing Jarrell Mason at quarterback, noticeable hit for the Bulldog offense. Much of the Bulldog offense was designed, Bo, as we saw on film, to be a read option type of an offense. And having Jarrell Mason back there, which, you know, he was a dual-threat quarterback. He was averaging 67 yards a game passing. But the thing is, too, he also had carried the ball 15 times already for the team. Since his injury, Coach Dover had looked for the answer. You mentioned the two backups that he was looking at. But together, they were only 4 of 8 passing so far in the last two games. And Myers, which is who we expect tonight, number 15, to be the starting quarterback for the Bulldogs, You know, he's only carried the ball six times, and that for minus 10 yards. And so you're kind of losing that effectiveness of that read option type of an offense from the Bulldogs simply because that quarterback's not a threat in on his own to run.
Juniors Xavier Burks and Ledrick Washington will be now, John, the Fairdale running attack. Both these guys, they got through the transfer portal, I guess you could say. We didn't have snippets of it for you this week, folks, but I did get to watch the Coach Marksbury show. He said there's six or seven transfers on this Fairdale team that, you know, that wasn't there last year, but Burks played at Male his freshman year, and he's battled his way back from a fractured kneecap last season, missed most of that year, but he's capitalized this year, John. 32 rushes, 378 yards, four touchdowns on the ground, and that's 11.8 yards a carry, but 339 of those yards and four of those touchdowns was last week against Eastern in a loss.
Yeah, and this is the offensive point of attack that the Bears need to focus on. As you mentioned, Burks, Washington, both great running backs for this Bulldog offense. You know, those Bulldogs, they can use these backs both in space, but then also you look at a back like Washington, what we saw on film. This is a guy that'll run through or even run over tackles. Bears must be aware of these two. Be sure tacklers are there together, working together, slow them down, group tackle, no arm tackling, nothing like that. Just trying to do what they can to get these guys on the ground and keep that rushing attack in check.
Washington was actually chosen as the preseason district player of the year in 5A District 4. But that was before the season started. He was actually enrolled at Seneca at the time, which is a different district than Fairdale. And his first three games this year, 24 carries, 163 yards, 106 yards in a week two loss to Fern Creek. And like you said, John, we've seen it in film. This guy's a hard runner, keeps the legs churning.
Yeah.
They also have senior Yanni Pearson. He's the leading returning running back for the Bulldogs this year. But, John, we didn't see any film of him over the last two games. Yeah. He was actually picked as the preseason district player of the year in 5A District 3, which is where Fairdale is actually at. And but we've not seen any film on him. We don't know if he's injured. We don't know a time frame. We don't even know if he's still a member of the team. But that's somebody else that you would have to watch for if he is over there on that sideline.
Yeah, it once again reminds me of Spencer County, especially in the past 2 years. The Fairdale offense, you know, between those guys, they're going to spend most of their night trying to move the football on the ground. But be careful, though. They do have a passing attack, I believe we're going to talk about here shortly, that you have some stats on. The way Spencer County's been able to play in the past, we've been able to use that running attack, try to draw the safety up. You see them walking forward. The next thing you know, you get a tight end, you get a wing, you get a receiver releasing, getting deep in that secondary, throw it over their heads, and it's an easy 6 points. So, Bo, as I said, sir, I said this earlier this week, and this, I'll stand by it in this game. Spencer County needs to sell out to stop the run. But we need somebody in that secondary always having their eye open and always looking for a receiver releasing off that line.
Now, over the summer, John, that quarterback Mason, who they thought was going to be QB1, had an injured shoulder. They shut him down as far as throwing the ball, and Coach Dover said they got a little behind implementing that passing game. But when they do get to pass the ball, it's very rare. Malik Battle is to be the main target.
Yep.
He has six catches for 94 yards and a touchdown. But, John, 45 of those yards was on one completion where the quarterback threw into triple coverage.
Yeah.
And that was a touchdown. So, of all the guys that we've mentioned between Mason, Washington, Burks, Pearson, and those guys, they've had their hands on the ball 124 of the 132 plays from scrimmage for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, that's an incredible stat right there for those guys. Tells you a lot about what they're trying to do. Of course, we're telling you from watching the film earlier this week, a heavy run type of an offense team, and Spencer County just needs to do their best, be able to come up, use those linebackers like they can, get good reads off of that, and get some good stops and shut that down. Bo, if it's me, I'm forcing them to beat me. If they're going to beat me, they're going to beat me through the air.
Now, defensively for the Bulldogs, they returned three of their top 11 tacklers from last year. But with the injury to Mason, that just leaves two. You got senior defensive tackle Makai Duncan, who is getting some looks from different colleges. He's 6'1", 325 pounds, John. And you'll also see him when they do run, which is rare, a wishbone formation on offense. You will see him as the fullback. It's almost like a refrigerator.
That's what I was going to say. Bo and I watching film Wednesday night, we saw this formation, number 52 lining up at fullback in that wishbone formation, and that's all I could say was the refrigerator Perry in there getting those blocks, trying to blow something open. You might see that from time to time in this game in short yardage situations. A lot of what we're going to see from Fairdale is going to be played out of the pistol formation or the shotgun formation, either one, spread out. But, yes, they do have that ground and pound if they bring everybody in and look for him to come in and play fullback.
Also have senior John Blinko Jr. He's 6'5", 255-pound defensive end. Also plays tight end. But as we watched pretty much every offensive play they've done this year, John, and I don't think they threw the ball to him one time. He's primarily a blocker on offense.
Yeah, you're not going to see a lot that way. And, of course, you know, you and I have already mentioned the fact that this team's going to try to run the ball. You know, in running the ball, we talked about it last week facing that South Oldham triple option team. As an offense, it does great things for you because if you can carry the football, you are forcing that defense to tackle you. Versus if you throw the football, an incompletion kind of bails the defense out. So you make sure you get the defense having to play their assignments. They have to get your guy on the ground. And so by doing that, controlling the tempo of the game, controlling the clock, that's the type of offensive attack we look to see out of these Bulldogs tonight.
Secondary is very quick. Sophomore Malik Smith, second on the team in tackles with 20. Junior Kwame Anderson has two interceptions on the year, John. Return one of those for a touchdown.
Yeah, and, you know, so you look at this entirety of this Bulldog defense and what we're talking about, where you're talking about Blinko and Duncan both on that defensive line and what they're able to do. You're talking about players in the secondary. Really, if I'm Spencer County, I'm trying to get the ball away from those guys in the middle. I'm trying to get the ball to the outside, try to do it quickly, get the ball into space. And if the Bears can get that to the outside edges and in space, I think they have a great shot of moving the chains and putting points on the board tonight.
So there you have a little bit about tonight's opponent. We're going to take another quick break. When we return, we'll have the Taylorsville Community Church John's Keys to the Game, and we'll get you set for kickoff. We are now about 13 minutes away on the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show on GHP Sports.
Offering all manner of body and mechanical work. Keep your vehicle looking and performing at its best. Conveniently located at 910 Taylorsville Road in Taylorsville, or find us on the web at Dougherty'sBodyShop.com. Dougherty's Body Shop and Service Center. Big or small, we fix it all.
Welcome back to Spencer County High School and the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show. And, John, let's look at our Taylorsville Community Church, John's Keys to the Game.
All right, I'm keeping one eye on the field right now, too, with the band set up out here. We might have to step away for a second for the next. Well, we are going to step away for a second. We'll come back after the national anthem with the Taylorsville Community Church Keys to the Game.
Junior ROTC, Cadets Neal, Cadets Manning, Cadets Prather, and Cadets Harris present our nation's colors. At this time, the Spencer County High School Band, under the direction of Head Band Director Tara Alcorn, Assistant Band Director Becca Owen, drum majors Emily Alcorn, Nathan Spencer, and Jasmine Dossman will play our national anthem.
All right, John, back here on the Kentucky 811 Call Before You Dig pregame show. We're going to do the Taylorsville Community Church keys to the game. And
Before we start this, any parents, any grandparents, any aunts and uncles, I just got to say, the band started playing the national anthem. I just want to tell you how proud we are of some of our young people. Looked over my right shoulder. Kids even out here on the practice field stopped, put their hands over their hearts. Very respectful. Be proud of those kids over there. That was awesome to see.
All right. First thing you got here, John, sell out to stop the run.
Yeah, and it's a lot of what we spent talking about in the beginning when with the Fairdale Bulldog offense. And what they're able to do offensively is, and it really is, it's kind of this read option look where they're going to try to work that running attack. And they're really going to play, I'm guessing, Bo, what, 80% of the time or so that they're going to be trying to run the football down the field. So on the defensive side, defensive line, linebackers, you got to be able to play your keys, got to be able to see what's going on, read those, make those stops.
Got to work the outside.
Got to work. We talked about this briefly right before we went to commercial a little bit ago when it come to dealing with the defensive line that Fairdale brings. You know, you sent me numbers earlier today talking about the size of Blinko and Duncan on the inside for Fairdale. That's somebody that with our young, kind of inexperienced offensive line that Spencer County has, they're going to be a handful to deal with. So Spencer County offense really needs to try to work those quick plays to the outside and be able to move that ball, get it into space, and just kind of stay away from those big guys, making it difficult for them to have an impact on the game.
Yeah, that Bulldog starting offensive line, John, averages 6'1", 241 pounds. Starting defensive line for the Bears averages 5'10", 189 pounds.
Yeah, there's a huge difference there.
All right, and then the last key to the game, don't stop believing.
I've been waiting to see if you were going to sing that or not, bringing the journey out for the last one here. Don't stop believing. Spencer County, keep in mind, all you Spencer County fans, everybody here tonight, or whether you're at home watching with us, this is an extremely tough schedule Coach Marksbury's had for the beginning of the season. A Hart County team who's top five in 3A, a Collins team that, after losing their opener to Shelby County, has just been rattling off win after win against great teams. And then, you know, we look at a South Oldham team who had lost early in the season to this Anderson of Ohio team, which is just this crazy big team the way it is. And so Spencer County, with the schedule that they have and the difficulty of that schedule, don't stop believing. We've got the talent on the field. We've got the Jimmies and the Joes we need out there to be able to get these wins, and this is a great opportunity tonight to get one of those.
Tonight's fireworks are compliments of
John,
Rocky
I said
Willie's
this last
fireworks.
Week. I'll say it again. The Bears have got to establish the run game. They are only averaging 112 yards a game on the ground right now. Now, we do have Jared Stewart. That's a dimension that we haven't had in this offense as far as a pro-style quarterback that we haven't seen in the past. And that's great. But last week, the Bears, they did run some three-wide formations, ran some bubble screens. I thought they worked really, really good. But this offense is based on running the football. That is the Spencer County Bear identity. That's what we've known as long as Coach Marksbury has been here with the wing T offense. They've got to get that number of 112 in the 225 to 250 range if we want to see them put some victories in the victory column.
You're exactly right, Bo. This offense, it is built around running the football. And in years past, the Bears have been able to have a strong rushing attack. And, you know, that rushing attack, what it did for them, it gave them that opportunity to set up those pass plays. We can even recall last season where the Bears were running the ball so well that every once in a while would release Kellen Marksberry, release Jonathan Combs off of the line at the tight end spot, be able to get them going up the seam. When you catch that safety cheating up, and the next thing you know, it's a pitch and catch for six. It's simple for them right there. But here now, and having the arm of Jarrett Stewart, as well as having the likes of Drew Barron, Kellen Marksberry, Eric Henry, having those weapons for Stewart to be able to catch the ball, you almost find yourself with the Bears needing to try to throw the ball in order to set up the run. They got to be able to do something to spread that defense out, be able to pull some of those defenders out of the box get them out of the way, and that gives you some more lanes, some more openness, a little less friction for the Bears running backs to be able to get upfield when they do run the football. But you're never going to get that respect on defense if you don't show that you can throw the ball. You're never going to get that open middle in the box if you don't make them respect the pass.
John, that's all we got for the Kentucky 811 call before you dig pregame show. We're going to take one more quick commercial break. And when we come back, the Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center Game of the Week, live here on GHP Sports.
Are you looking for a reputable shop to take care of your ride? Stop by Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center, offering all manner of body and mechanical work to keep your vehicle looking and performing at its best. Conveniently located at 910 Taylorsville Road in Taylorsville, or find us on the web at DaughertysBodyShop.com. Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center. Big or small, we fix it all.
Welcome back to Spencer County High School. We get ready for the Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center Game of the Week. Get ready to see the Bears take the field, John, and have the future Bears leading them through the tunnel. This is such an exciting moment for these young kids.
I love
man.
This. Yeah, as we look at the clock leading out here, 2 minutes, 12 seconds, still kickoff.
You look down below us here, John. You talk about the don't stop believing. This student section hasn't stopped believing.
No,
it is
have.
Packed with it's neon safety jackets. I mean, bright pink.
I'm sending some of these kids to work for me here at the beginning of the week down here and getting them.
That Cam turn around looking at us.
And here we go. The Spencer County Bears take the field.
And here are your
That's awesome.
That is great. Once again, if you're just joining us, Future Bears Night here at Spencer County High School. As you've seen, the Future Bears, the Stallions football players, the middle school football players leading the high school onto the field here at the Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center Game of the Week. And, Bo, I'm ready. I don't know about you. I'm jacked up for this one.
I am, too. I'm ready to go. I got faith in this Bears team, John. I know Coach Marksbury said they went back, said we're going back to our identity, who we are as a team. So I look for them to get that ground game established and go back to some of the plays we seen last year where we talked about leaking a receiver out deep after you suck those linebackers in and Jared Stewart could hit them deep.
That's right.
In that passing game. The Bears got to get this running game established.
We missed the coin toss, but –
does look like Fairdale is going to kick off.
Whether the Bears won and wanted the ball or if Fairdale won and deferred, we do know Spencer County will have the ball to start the game. Fairdale will then receive the football to start the second half.
One opportunity. He sees everything you ever wanted. One moment. Did you capture it?
The ball's teed up.
Bulldogs getting ready to kick off. We do have Ethan Hampton back deep for the Bears. A little different setup for the Bears here, John, on the kickoff. Usually see Killen. Oh, we got an onside kick.
Get on it. Get on it.
Fairdale ball.
Fairdale with a little trickery to start this game. And, you know, from time to time, you're going to see things like that. You even see it in, like, a college-level type game to where juiced up, jacked up, you know what's going to happen, or you think you do if you're the receiving team. Got your guys deep, ready to set up a return. And as soon as that kicker's running up on that football, a lot of the front line guys start to turn away to run backwards, and they just weren't ready for that. So, Fairdale, being able to take one away from Spencer County there, will start with the ball on the Spencer County 49.
First and 10. Handoff goes to Burks.
And he's still churning his legs. People.
John, he was hit behind the line of scrimmage and carried that pile almost 10 yards.
Yeah, I think they're going to give him 8 on that. It's going to bring a second down and 2.
8-yard carry, second and 2.
Great read by the linebackers. Great penetration by the defensive line on Spencer County, but just have to do a better job of getting him on the ground quicker.
Myers, the quarterback for Fairdale, got trips out wide to the right from the shotgun. Hand off again to Washington up the middle. Going to get about another 10 yards, John, on that run. Good enough for a Bulldog first down. The first and 10 marking at about the 32 of Spencer County.
Yeah, Spencer County defense right here. Going to have to buckle those chin straps just a little bit tighter, I think. You know, Fairdale already trying to impose their will on that offensive side of the ball using that rushing attack. We knew it was going to happen. Again, about 80% of the offensive attack is going to come on the ground. Spencer County needs to be able to shoot those gaps and get these stops. You know, sure tackle. If nothing else, hang on and wait for help to come.
Twins to the right. Handoff this time goes to Washington.
And there we are.
The Bears collect him up.
And that tackle for a loss.
It's like Jace Phelps along with several other Bears.
Yeah, I think I see Ian Blanford getting up from that. Also Nick Stowe coming up from that pile. And that's what I'm talking about. Get a hold of them, wait on help. And that's exactly what they were able to do, get a 1-yard loss. Going to bring up a second down and 11 for the Bulldogs.
Hand off to the up back, hit at the line of scrimmage again by Jacob Biller. He's going to get forward for about a yard, John. Get back to the original line of scrimmage. That'll bring up third down and 10.
Yeah, great job there by Jacob to be able to come down the line and be able to make that stop. Third and long. This is the type of situation the Bears want to keep the Bulldogs in during this game. A team that we know is not very effective throwing the football. You put them at third and behind the chains, and you make it very difficult for their offense to really be able to do something to get that 10 yards.
Four down territory here, no doubt, for the Bulldogs. Handoff goes around the right side. Going to go down about the 23-yard line. Going to be a little short of the first down.
I think he's, yeah, about a yard short.
After a 9-yard carry.
That was Ledrick Washington on the carry.
Fourth and 1.
And as you mentioned, we're sitting here. It's going to be fourth and short. Number 52.
Here you go.
Makai Duncan checking in for the Bulldogs. Look to see this wishbone formation for the first time and see if the big man can blow a hole open for him.
Myers up under center. 325-pound fullback. They're going to give the ball to Washington. It's going to be close, John.
It's going to depend on the spot. I think
the one on the near side is going to give it to him, I do believe.
I think they got it, yep. Pickup of about 2 yards when they only needed one.
Spencer County ball.
Oh! Did not see that happen. Fumble on the carry. Spencer County football takes over on their own 21-yard line.
First and 10 for the Bears from their own 21-yard line.
Well, we got a replay of that. See if we can get that real quick in. Country Mark, instant replay of the fumble. Runner stayed up, and yeah, and as he's falling backwards, he's without the football.
Keenan Carnes picked that up. Handoff up the middle goes to Armstrong. He gets turned, maybe picks up a yard on that play. Bring up second down and 9.
Short game, second and 9.
Still interested and kind of waiting to see if Spencer County is going to try to open up their formations at all. You mentioned it earlier in the pregame of how we saw a couple times last week where they did a 3-wide type of formation, try to spread that defense out. And here we do have set up twins right.
Hand off to Marksbury. Tries to get around the right edge. Going to get forward, pushed out of bounds about the 32, maybe 33-yard line.
38-yard line.
It's going to be about a gain of 4 or 5.
Be about 3 yards short of the first down. Bring up third and 3. This is the Spencer County ball we're used to, John.
Exactly.
You get third and manageable here. That's all you can ask for.
Well, it opens up the playbook so much. Even if Coach Marksbury wanted to roll the dice here and go with a longer passing play, if he still wants to use his rushing attack, there's so many things you can do in this situation to pick up those 3 yards.
Hand off to Hampton. He's got forward. I believe he's got enough for the first down. He does.
Yep.
Have not motioned to move the sticks yet.
Yeah,
now
there
they
it
do.
Is. First down, Spencer County.
For another.
First and 10 Bears. They're on 32-yard line.
That's the type of offense we need to see from Spencer County, at least one that's moving the chains. You do that, you give your defense a little bit more time to catch their breath on the sidelines, be a little more effective coming out on the second possession for Fairdale.
And off to Armstrong. Going to get forward for about 3. Up to the 35-yard line.
Be second and 8.
Great job on the offensive line here on the left side, Bo. If we can get a replay of that play, you'll see this offensive line collapsing down on the inside, blocking down, taking that defensive tackle, taking that middle linebacker, and opening up that corner enough to give him a little running room and to pick up those 3 yards. You see here, Connor Lawson goes down. Picks up that. I mean, when you have a defensive line with the size that Fairdale has, you have to be able to work that leverage, work those angles to try to get these running lanes open.
Barron split out wide. Handoff goes to Marksbury. Tries to get around the corner. Gets across the 40. Going to go out of bounds about the 44-yard line. That'd be good enough for another Bears first down.
Spencer County keeping those sticks moving. We didn't talk about it much in pregame, but this Fairdale team, we did mention they are 1-2 coming into this game. Their one win over Elizabethtown, came, I believe, the score 14-13 final score. And
they're right here.
And yeah, and that
14-12.
14-12. And that's when they also had Mason, their original starting quarterback, in. And so having lost him, losing the last two games, they're looking
across
for an
the
identity.
Middle. Pass was just a little bit behind Marksbury. Incomplete.
Second and 10 from the Bears, 44.
Second down and 10 for the Bears. This is the first road game for Fairdale this year, John, too.
Yeah.
That could weigh on them just a little bit.
And to come to an environment like this, I mean, look around. We got the stands are full. We've got the future Bear night, all the cheerleaders in front. We got the people sitting out here by the concession stands. I'm not sure if the speakers are still on listening to us right now. We appreciate y'all. This is a great atmosphere for Spencer County tonight.
That time, Brody Phelps gets around the left edge.
Don't see where they marked him. I think he's just shy, about a yard
about
shy.
About a yard short,
yep. 53-yard line, third and 1.
.516 left to go in the first. The third down and 1 for the Bears.
Already seeing a few hands on the hips here for the Bulldog defense.
Barron out wide to the left. That's short side of the field. We'll get a timeout, Spencer County here.
Yeah,
might have been a little confusion.
I don't think the coach liked what he's seen. We do
Bears.
Have a couple coaches up here with us, and they were saying check off down to Coach Marksbury, letting him know there was something, whether it was our alignment, whether it was a defensive alignment, something they didn't like about that with that play call. And on a situation like this, third and one, kind of around midfield, I don't know that this is a spot where Coach Marksberry would be playing for two downs. I think this is where you really want to try to pick up that first down on third down. And if we don't, I would imagine he would probably have to punt the ball. You know, last week we talked about field position being such an issue for the Spencer County Bears and what they gave up to South Oldham, these short fields and these easy scores. You know, without that, it might have been a little bit different ball game, given an opportunity for Spencer County's offense to work a little bit more. So very important play here early in this drive for Spencer County. 4:47 left to go in the first quarter. And we'll see what Coach Marksberry and the other coaches dial up here for this third down.
Phelps changes over to the left side. Barron out wide to the left. Stewart's just going to keep that himself. Dive forward. He's going to pick up about three on that job. Yeah. Good enough for the Bears first down.
Great call right there. Spencer County goes to the line.
That's good.
Yeah, we talked about the strength of the defense of the Fairdale Bulldogs. It didn't look like, from our point of view anyway, that nobody ever really lined up in the A-gap for those tackles. Nobody was playing that down low to be able to stop that. Easy lane for Jarrett Stewart to pick up those 3 yards. First down, we keep the chains moving.
It's time both Kellen Marksberry and Barron out to the wide side of the field. Stewart checking off the play. Smith goes in motion, gets the pitch. Gets around the right side. Good block by Marksberry. Makes the man miss. Gets across the 40. Down to about the 37-yard line.
Gary May to the Bears.
Pick up about 8 on that play, John.
Bo, I'll take those all night long. That's great right there, because you have that. And the biggest thing I liked about that, Smith being able to sit back there, watch for his blocks. Kellen Marksberry being able to go down, try to kick that corner, that outside linebacker out to the outside. While he waited on that, being able to turn upfield, easily gained an extra 4 or 5 yards on that run simply because he was patient.
Stewart looks to pass. Got a man across the middle. Marksberry unseen. Picked off. Intercepted by Kwame Anderson. Caught from behind by Marksberry.
And Marksberry getting up, holding that right shoulder. He struggled with that last week.
The Bulldogs take over from their own 34. First and 10.
Turnovers hurt, Bo. Turnovers hurt.
First and 10 Bulldogs from their own 34-yard line. 3:07, see there on the country marked instant replay. 3:07 left to go in the first. Myers from the gun, got a running back on either hip, one split out wide each way. Could have been a flag there, John.
I think they're going to finally get it. Yep, we do have a false start. We have Mike Phillips with us this week. Mike, you have anything for us down there?
I think I figured out y'all just use me every other week. Y'all think y'all wear me out or something, and I need a week off every other week?
Well, no, you're not getting off. Any younger. You're not getting any younger.
Oh,
that's
I know
all.
That. Trust me. Now, good offensive drive there. Just that ball was underthrown a little bit. Defense has looked a little better on that first drive, causing a fumble. If we win that turnover battle, that's usually a predictor of the scoreboard.
Two possessions, two turnovers so far in this ball game, one for either side. Lefty throws it through the hands of Malik Battle.
Pass falls in.
That bring up second down and 15. Jarrell Butler now checking in at quarterback. This is the freshman, John. So we've already seen both quarterbacks. Got one split out wide each way. from the shotgun. Handoff goes to Washington. Nothing Bears there. Caught big in the backfield. They'll lose probably three on that play.
Piller.
Derek Piller, his son out there. Derek, a friend of ours, worked with him, does stats for us for basketball. Proud of his boy, Jacob Piller, right there, crashing down from the defensive end spot, taking that guy down. Loss of yards on that play. And now we're looking at
third and 18.
Third and 18. For, again, a team that's not really known for their passing attack. So Spencer County definitely needs to watch for these receivers here. Don't take your eye off of that back, though. You never know when they might try to slip something in.
Trips out to the right. Bears coming. And Nick Stowe's going to get the sack.
Sack number 30.
Another loss on the play.
Great job by the Bears secondary. Had those receivers locked down. We've talked about it before. You get in a situation like that, and really a quarterback's only going to have 2 to 3 seconds to try to get rid of that football in any sort of effective way. Nick Stowe able to use that to his advantage to be able to get upfield and make that stop.
Punt. Marksbury's going to let it hit and roll. Going to take a Fairdale bounce down to about the 34, 35-yard line. Over. That's where the Bears will take over with a minute 38 left to go in the first quarter.
The Spencer County Bears offense now having a little bit of an opportunity here off the sidelines. Talk about some things, talk about some adjustments and how they can do some things differently. Really do look to see more of the same out of them on this drive. They still are going to try to use that running attack that's been effective for them so far, Bo, being able to pick up 3, 4, 5 yards of carry to keep those chains moving. And just like last year, you lull that defense into sleep. You'll find number 22 here, safety for the Bulldogs, start working his way up, and that's when you have an opportunity to burn them deep.
Handoff up the middle. Danny Armstrong's going to get forward for about 11 yards.
Yeah, that's going to be good enough for a first down, too,
I
believe.
Give him 10. He's right on the line. They're moving the chains.
Carry made the Bears' 45-yard line, and that's good for another.
It's a couple times Danny's got forward for a couple good runs there, John. They're gapping that defensive line, and that's some big boys down there.
There are, and I'm thrilled to see this from the Spencer County offensive line that we've noticed from time to time in those first few games that kind of struggled, doing a great job with their assignments so far tonight, blowing these holes open, getting those angles, and giving a place for our running
backs to go. Reverse on counter back to Marksbury, gets across midfield, going to go down about the Fairdale 49-yard line, pick up about six on that play, bring up second down and four. Bears going to have to run one more play here.
Yeah, I think so.
Second and four.
We might even see how aggressive Coach Marksbury might be. You know, 40 seconds left to go in the quarter. Might try to get two of them off.
Bearing out wide to the right. And get another timeout.
Yeah, Spencer County. The coaches didn't like something of what they saw, whether it was a personnel issue. Second down and mid-range, I mean, you don't look at this typically as being that big of a play, Bo. You know, normally you're looking at those third down plays being the ones that you've really got to work hard at and that these are important plays. Or if you go for a fourth down conversion, just how important those are. These second down plays could really, you know, give an offense a lot of advantages. Even in this spot where we see we're second and four, if we only pick up just 3 yards on second down, you get yourself to a spot where your third and one can do a lot of different things. But if something happens that's wrong, if you have different personnel, if you have something going on where a player doesn't quite understand what's happening, that second down play, if it gets blown up and puts yourself at third and 7 or 8 or even behind the chains, then you get yourself in a bad spot to try to get that third down conversion made and to be able to keep the chains moving down the field.
17.1 seconds left. Handoff, Armstrong hit at the line of scrimmage and dropped. May have got a foot on that, John.
Yeah. Xavier Burks being able to come down in his position there from linebacker.
Carry for no gain.
That's going to bring us to the end of the first quarter and your score after one. Spencer County 0, Fairdale 0. We'll be right back on GHP Sports. Welcome back to
SCHS. Sorry. I get into it, Bo. I mean, these are great, great Friday nights.
The Doherty's Body Shop and Service Center game of the week tonight. Spencer County playing Fairdale. Score tied at 0 after 1, John. I got a few stats here. We'd like to thank Denise for helping us out. Your wife.
Yep, lovely wife. Yep.
Howie skipped town on us, and we'll get him back for that. But appreciate Denise coming in and helping us out. Looks like the Bears 11 rushes for 57 yards in that first quarter. That's already more rushing yards than they had all last week.
Exactly.
So that is a plus. Four first downs for the Bears. And on the Fairdale side, they've got 13 yards of total offense seven on eight plays. So
Spencer Bears County, two wideouts on this play. They move.
Kellen in motion, gets the pitch. Cuts back, midfield.
Nice block by Schuler.
It's going to get across the 35 up to about the 33-yard line, go out of bounds.
Play by number three, Marksberry, and that's good for another.
Look at this replay. We're going to see it here. Tanner Schuler coming from his guard position, pulling to the outside, and he didn't just get to the outside, Bo. His head was on a swivel. Look at 55 come around right there, able to get to the outside, be able to make that block to spring the running back. Great job, Tanner Schuler. Great block, Spencer County first down.
First and 10, ball at the Fairdale 33-yard line. Barron out wide to the right. Handoff. Phelps up the middle. Gets across the 25 down to about the 22-yard line. That's going to be another Bears first down.
Bo. 22, and that's good for another.
There's people, of course, have seen us on camera. There's people that are here now listening to us that can see us. You or I could have ran through that hole that the offensive line just opened up for the Spencer County Bears there. Great job, again, getting good leverage on these larger Bulldog defensive line players, blowing these holes open, making it just kind of easy at times for the Spencer County running back to find space.
Fairdale timeout here, John. Be their first taking timeout in the first half. Bears starting to work their identity like we talked about before the game.
Yep.
Get that running game going. You end up sucking them linebackers up, and when you do, that's when you hit them where it hurts.
Well, and that's what we've talked about, too, about a quick attack. Spencer County has to work fast, whether it's the passing attack, whether it's the rushing attack. The things that happen have to happen quick. You've got a Fairdale defense right now already back on their heels trying to stop even the rushing attack. The passing attack, which is something we highlighted in the pregame with Jarrett Stewart and what he's able to do with having receivers like Drew Barron, Kellen Marksberry, Eric Henry available to him, really been non-existent so far in this game for the Bears, and it really hasn't had to exist. Spencer County doing a great job, again, blocking up front. You got linemen getting to the second level to block these linebackers and really going to change the rest of this game by changing that Fairdale defense. And in Bo, like years past, going to give us an opportunity to open up our passing game based off the fact that they're going to sell out to try to stop our rushing attack.
First and 10 Bears. Fairdale 22-yard line. Stewart. Handoff goes to Marksberry. Got room going around the edge. Gets up to about the 20. He's going to pick up two on that play.
Second and 7.
Second down and 8.
Yeah, Ryan Toby pulling around out there trying to lead block for Marksberry on the outside. Having a difficult time with that corner being able to hold him down and he was able then to make that tackle against Kellen Marksberry, limiting us to that 2-yard gain.
This crowd is unbelievable tonight, John.
Oh, I love it.
I mean, the stands are full. All the kids are down behind the end zone. I bet there's 100 kids over here on the practice field. Hand off to Phelps. Makes a couple guys miss. Cuts back toward the middle. Going to get up to about the 15-yard line.
Yeah, I think they're going to spot Phelps. Him just beyond there. Still going to put us in a third
about
down and manageable.
Third and three.
Yeah, third and three. A long two-ish for the Spencer County offense. And in a great spot of the field right here. Be interesting to see exactly the offensive attack that we do here. Because, again, Bo, this rushing attack has been so good that it is going to open up that passing game for us. And we are going to find guys just out by themselves in no man's land being able to receive some passes and possibly score.
Barron way out wide to the right. Pitch to Marksbury. Marksbury gets across the 15. Good block by Drew Barron. Marksbury's going to go down about the 2-yard line.
Marksbury carried down the Bulldogs.
That will be enough for a first down to bring up first and goal for the Bears.
First and goal for the Bears.
See our Country Mart instant replay. He's not even in the picture now, but Drew Barron got a good block right here.
Yeah, able to see
Kellen cut back.
Yep.
And almost get into the end zone.
Bears find themselves in kind of unfamiliar territory right now so far for the season. Pitch to Marksbury. He's going to walk in. Touchdown, Bears!
Number three, Kellen Marksbury.
And the drought is over.
91 minutes of play clock, John, since the Bears last scored a touchdown. Last scored a point.
Yeah. It's good for a $25 donation for Kentucky Farm Bureau agent.
Second quarter against Collins.
Yeah. We'll take care of all your insurance needs.
Kyle Brentzel on for the PAT. Good to see Kyle back. Had a little bit of an injury in that Collins game.
Oh, and it's straight and true.
Straight through. No.
Boy,
they're saying no good.
No, no, they said it's good. They said it's good.
Bristol. And that's successful point after attempt. Correction. No good.
No, they said it's no good. Now, here's that replay here. And watch Kellen Marksbury. Is he coming out? Of course, Smith getting a great block, sealing off that outside. Kellen, I mean, he could have just taken a sandwich with him and munched on it halfway to the end zone. Nobody in the area walks into the end zone for the six. Spencer County now bringing out their kicking team. And we'll get an opportunity once again to see a defense, Bow that's been really stout against this Fairdale rushing offense.
Tommy Childress on to kick off for the Bears. 8:52 left to go in the first half. Bears lead 6-0. All field at about the 5-yard line. That is Ledrick Washington. He's going to get back almost to the 30, John. Up to about the 27. Looks like they're going to mark him.
To the Bears 28. Or to the Bulldogs 28. First and 10.
I'm still waiting to see where I put the football down. The line judge kind of standing there. There we go. At the 27-yard line is where they're going to take over. Spencer County Bears defense doing a great job in this game. Defensive line, linebackers both, phenomenal job stopping this rushing attack. Yeah, Fairdale's had a few that they've broke a little bit, but Spencer County tightened up. Of course, we know Coach Eldridge makes excellent adjustments.
And up the middle, legs keep churning. Going to get forward for about 10 on that play. He's going to be real close to Marker.
The Bulldogs 37. First
they are moving
10.
To change. First and 10, Bulldogs.
Yeah, Xavier Burks there on the run. We talked about him also in the pregame show between him and Washington and just how strong a running backs those guys are. And this is where this team's going to live is between the tackles. If they're successful Nine times out of ten with carrying the football, it's going to be between the tackles. Spencer County linebackers need to be able to get up, gang tackle, be able to get those guys on the ground quick.
Hand off to Burks. Gets hit in the back.
And there they are.
Back. Nick Stowe.
That run stop. 1 yard gain, second and nine.
Here's a replay of that on our Country Mart instant replay. Stowe coming down this line. Watch him make this read.
Wide locker also
down.
Chasing from behind.
Jacob Box there, the guard for the Bulldogs, trying to come down. His responsibility was to get to Stowe, just too late. Stowe making that read, had a step on him, able to get in there and make that tackle.
Trips out to the left. Myers from the shotgun. Steps forward in the pocket. Now he's
on the ground.
Bears ball.
Bears ball.
It's still up.
Picked up.
Bears.
Touchdown, Bears!
Tanner Shuler picks up the fumble and takes it to the house.
Number 55, Tanner Shuler. That fumble recovery for a touchdown is good for a $25 donation from Kentucky Farm Bureau agent Earl Brownie. Stop by the office and let Earl take care of all your insurance needs.
So we're going to line up here.
Send the offense out on the field. Looks like they want to go for two here.
That's what they're going to do. Going to see Spencer County try for the two-point conversion here. We will have a replay of that touchdown. We scoop and score, I guess would be the right way to say it for Tanner Shuler. But trying to make up the difference in that. Hurrying up, trying to catch them out of position, and that's going to cause Fairdale to have to use a timeout.
Timeout taken by the Bulldogs.
They were not ready for the Bears to go for two there, John. They had to rush their defensive line out on the field.
Yeah, and Coach Dover was about ready to rush out there with them.
Country Mart instant replay. Myers just loses it, John.
As the ball's loose on the ground, going after it. Nobody has possession of it right now.
Locker. It's on the ground. And then, Tanner Shuler just grabs it. It's just laying there.
Yep.
I think I'll take this and take it to the house with me.
Yep, thank you very much. Scoop and score, Tanner Shuler. We've already mentioned his name a few times on offense, being able to pull around and get some of the blocks he's getting on the outside. Now to be able to put 6 points on the board for himself. And here we are, Bo.
You got a linebacker or an offensive lineman, which Tanner plays.
Yeah.
He gets to score a touchdown.
That doesn't happen often.
That's a big deal,
that
man.
That is a big deal.
Yeah.
So that's awesome right there. So, of course, now after the Fairdale timeout, we do expect Coach Marksberry to stay with his original decision as we see Jarrett Stewart come back out on the field for this two-point conversion attempt.
Bears coming out in a hurry. Stewart under center. Pitch to Marksberry. Fumbles.
Two-point conversion is no good.
And the ball's picked up by Makai Duncan, and the two-point try is no good. So a 7:05 left to go in the first half. Spencer County 12, Fairdale 0. Phillips, what do you see down there?
I mean, that's huge for our defense. You know, they gave up a lot of points last week, but didn't necessarily play bad. I tell Marksberry this week, I felt like they played on a 40-yard field all week. You know, the field position game we lost, that's just huge for a defense that, you know, when it was 47 or 49-0 last week, that's a huge thing to not only you're standing your ground here throwing a shutout, but to get a scoop and score like that is huge for your – you can tell they're licking their chops. They're tired. They're looking for water, but they're ready to get back on the field. That's a good sign.
All right, we appreciate that, Phillips. We are glad to have you, even though it might only be every other game.
I'll take what y'all can give me.
We'll get you a little jazzy scooter to come out in the next one to help you out.
No. I'm just glad to help. We appreciate what y'all do every week. People don't know what kind of time y'all put in. I was leaving here at 3:30 or 4 o'clock today, and that truck was pulling in. So y'all been here a while, so it's just all for these kids. Y'all do an amazing job. And I love that student section being right there below you all, too.
I do, too. I'm glad they moved it back. Ball picked up at the 1 yard line. Cuts back to the right.
Oh, grabbed nowhere to go.
Jacob Biller.
23 yard line.
In on that tackle for the Bears. No, Biller's coming on the side.
No, no, I believe that was Eric Henry. So the Spencer County defense, fresh off of a scoop and score. Got a lot of energy right now. I mean, now's the time. Keep focused. Pay attention. Get your assignments. Make sure you fill those holes. Shut them down again, and Spencer County will have a lot of momentum going. And remember, Fairdale will receive the second half kick. So Spencer County really wanting an opportunity to get this football back before halftime and put another six on the board.
Hand off. This time goes to Burks.
Stowe.
Hit again and push back.
Stowe and Biller both. Jacob Biller having just a highlight reel type of game, as well as Nick Stowe so far in this first half, being able to get in and make these tackles. We were concerned about some of the size that Fairdale brought to the offensive line and just how easy it would be for our guys to move. Speed is just prevailing so far for the Spencer County defense.
Second down, 9 for the Bulldogs. Twins out either way. Man goes in motion.
Ball's on the ground. Bears picked up again. Bears ball.
They're saying that's it's a pitch forward. That's an incomplete pass.
Yeah.
Pass falls incomplete. Third and 10.
That is probably
the
correct call.
We have the replay here. We have the replay right here.
He pitched it up. That is the correct call.
It was a pitch by about 6 inches, if you want to call it a pitch. That was.
If that's a handoff, that is a fumble. But where it is a pitch, that is considered a forward pass.
Live. That was, in my book, that was a fumble watching it.
Out, busted play. Keenan
Carnes
with the sack.
Keenan Carnes.
Sideway, number 33, Keenan Carnes.
And linebackers just having a field day out there for Spencer County. Let's see this replay here. Nobody picks up Keenan Carnes, lined up on the right side. Offensive tackle goes down to take Biller. Nobody home in the backfield. Clean line.
That was supposed to be a handoff for Washington. That's a busted play right from the get-go. That could have been offsides. Punt is up. Hawksbury is going to let that bounce. Yep. Yeah, that's got to be the injury there, John. Normally, Kellen takes that and takes off with it.
Yeah, we do have
officials
coming up. I do
think that
–
I don't
– yeah, here it is. It's over on our sidelines. We do have a flag.
They didn't get
– we got an illegal shift on the offense, on the kicking team.
Illegal motion on the kicking team.
And Coach Marksberry is going to back him up those 5 yards for that penalty. Force them to re-kick, which will make it a 4th and 21 for the kick with 5:23 left to go in the half. And, Bo, as I was mentioning before, Fairdale – actually set to receive the kickoff to start the second half. So this is a great opportunity for Spencer County with a lot of clock left in this second quarter, be able to put points on the board again and then have that opportunity to go into halftime with an even bigger lead. So now I think they got the ball placement right. Yep, 4th and 21.
Marksberry standing at midfield. Punt is up. It's going to land at midfield. Kellen picks it up about the 42-yard line. Tries to get across the field. He's going backwards, John. He's going to get out of bounds at the 40. Lost about 7 or 8 yards. Now we got
a flag
coming in late.
There's a flag on the play.
Way away from where Kellen was running.
Kellen was already out of bounds when the official pulled the flag out of his pocket. And it's on the other side of the field.
We're going to have a block in the back on Spencer County.
Block in the back on the Bears.
the spot on the foul. That's going to back him up. We'll put the ball somewhere around looking the 35-yard line to take over. 5:09 left to go in the second quarter. The
Bears will take over. First and 10 from their own 35-yard line.
See if the Bears can put one more on the board here, John. Barron and Marksbury out wide to the right. Smith goes in motion. Long pass downfield. He just overthrows Drew Barron.
Pass falls incomplete.
Second, like that play call. Like that play call. You get a situation like that, you get that ball back after a huge stop on third down, forcing that punt. Spencer County taking a shot right away while they have decent field position. Still plenty of clock to work with to move the chains and be able to get downfield for the rest of this second quarter. But I like that. You really test that defense when – honestly, Bo, a majority of our first down plays have been rushing plays. And so you get linebackers, you get corners, safeties, looking to that inside to see what's going to happen. Sneak somebody by them, and it's a cheap six.
Hand off to Phelps. Gets around the left side.
Oh, big hit.
And we got a flag coming in late here.
That was in the backfield.
Flag on the play.
Waiting for the signal from the official. We're going to have a legal block type of a situation call there.
See our Country Mart instant replay here.
At the flag.
You see Smith coming down and just coming up from the secondary, number 20, Malik Smith for the Fairdale Bulldogs.
Second and 25.
Coming up and laying the wood on Smith. That penalty, though, 15-yard penalty against the Bears. It's going to back us up second and 25 from the 20-yard line. Spencer County with quite a long field to go here.
Stewart under center. Man goes in motion. Takes a snap. Quick screen. Out to Barron. Barron cuts back. Gets across the 25. And that's probably going to give him progress up to the 26.
Catch and carry.
Pick up of six on the play.
25-yard line. 27-yard line.
See, now if you're Coach Marksbury, you're thinking field position. You're going to try to do what you can. Obviously, you want to pick up this first down, any coach would. But in that, you don't want to lose yardage on a play like this. You want to have that opportunity to at least get positive yards. And if you can't pick up that first down, let Tommy Childress come out, switch the field for you, flop the field for you to put Fairdale back deep. And with the clock the way it is, both teams with one timeout, try to shut them down, maybe get an opportunity to score again before the halftime, but we'll have to see.
That goes to Marksbury. Tries to get to the left side. Not there. Going to lose more yardage.
Carry for no gain. Fourth and 18.
I think he got back to the line of scrimmage. But still going to force a punting situation here for the Bears. Penalties just riddling that possession, Bo, and making it difficult for them to really get much momentum going. Tommy Childress, though, back out to punt. We've seen him have some incredibly long punts. And
he's a good weapon to have. Fairdale looks like they're all coming here. Bad snap over his head. Just got to kick it out of bounds.
Yep, that's what you have to do. It's going to end up being a safety.
Yep. Now, very smart play right there by Childress.
Snap was high coming from Jacob Biller.
Safety on the Bears.
Let's take a chance. Let's take a look at this Country Mart instant replay. Again, the snap just over Tommy's head. No chance, but good awareness by Tommy Childress back there to be able to kick that ball out of bounds, out of the back of the end zone, forcing the safety versus giving up a potential touchdown if Fairdale were to jump on that football. So,
and give the kid credit. I mean, this is a kid that's he's only played three games of varsity football, and to know to do that in that situation.
Yeah, that's just football IQ right there. Yep. And so great job of him. Great job of the coaches if they'd worked with him on that, if they'd ever talked to him about that. You know, obviously pretty important thing that we needed to have come up in a situation like that. So that's going to bring the ball up to, I believe, the 20-yard line is where we'll punt the football from.
The free kick.
Yeah, this will be a free kick. Oh, he actually will be able to tee the ball up.
Washington standing on his own 35-yard line. 3:21 left to go in the half.
Booming
golly. That ball picked up at the 14-yard line.
Great coverage, too. Tommy Childress just sending a rocket down.
66 yards, that kick.
66 yards. It didn't get 10 yards in the air. A bullet down through there. Coverage getting downfield the way it did, being able to push the Fairdale Bulldogs back to around the 26-yard line, I believe. How low this kick is.
I do believe my Eastern Kentucky came out there when he booted that.
Fairdale Bulldogs will take over at the 26-yard line. 3:15 remaining in the half.
Bring it to the press box now.
Myers from the gun, one wide out either way. Should have been a flag. Pass out to the flat. It's complete up to about the 32-yard line.
Nick Stowe in there on the tackle.
Pick up about six.
Oh, they're going to give him seven or eight, looking like, on that from the spot of about 7-yard gain.
The Bulldogs, 33. Second and five.
Going to bring up about a second and three.
Same formation. Running backs moving every time, John. Got a hold there that they missed. Picked up Kellen Marksbury, the initial hit.
Nick Stowe cleaning it up. We do have a flag on the play.
Once again, if
that's got
to
be a hold.
Needs to be announced here in the future Bears.
That's completely on the back side of the play here, John.
In the press box now.
We're going to have a personal foul, face mask against the defense.
Face mask on the Bears.
That personal foul, that's
15-yard penalty, first down for the Bulldogs at midfield.
15-yard penalty on the Bears, first automatic first down. .205 left to go in the half. Handoff. Burks bounces off a would-be tackle.
He's got a little room, too.
He's going to get around the edge.
Drew Barron
grabs him by the ankles, gets him to go out of bounds. It's going to be down around the 22-yard line. Barron a little slow to get up.
21.
Dangerous possession here for the Fairdale Bulldogs. They have an opportunity. We saw this last week with South Oldham to be able to get a first down, be able to move the football down here, getting almost to the red zone. and an opportunity to possibly put points on before they go in the half, knowing that they're going to get the opening kickoff of the second half. It's a chance for them to double up. It's a coach's dream.
Burks bounced off his own lineman there. Pistol formation, trips out to the right. Handoff, Burks grabbed immediately in the backfield. I believe that was
Wyatt Walker. On the ground? They're saying he was down. Ball came loose at the end, but the official coming in, line judge coming in, saying the runner was down. Burke kind of slow to get up after that, too. He's not moving too awful well right now. Stays on the field.
Pistol formation again. One wide out either way. Snap. Myers looks to throw. He's left. He's got to turn it. Complete. Right about the 10-yard line. That'll be enough for a first down.
Catch made at the Bears' 10-yard line.
Yeah, that was Blinko out there. We talked about him at the beginning of the game, how he might release off of that tight end spot, be able to pick up a few receptions for the Bulldogs. And Myers able to find him there, able to make a good catch. Not a lot of yards after contact for him, but they keep the chains moving, bring up a first and goal.
Inside a minute left to go in the half. Each team with one timeout. Myers from the gun. Handoff goes to Burke. He's in the end zone. Touchdown.
Touchdown for the Bulldogs. Number six.
Xavier Burks. Scores that will make it 12-8. I would think they'll go for two here.
They could potentially go for two. Even going for one, they end up leaving themselves just three points behind. So
offense is on the field. Myers looking to pass. Guy's in trouble. Jump pass. Knocked down by Ethan Hampton, but caught in the back of the end zone. Incomplete.
Incomplete, but wow.
Ethan Hampton got up, got his hand on that one.
No good.
And the two-point try is no good.
Let's see that touchdown run again here.
Spencer County 12, Fairdale 8.
That touchdown run again here on the Country Mart Instant Replay. Spencer County, most of the time through this first half, doing a great job up front. Fairdale just catches him off guard, able to get some leverage and move those guys, and Burke just able to bulldoze his way into the end zone for six. Still, Spencer County with a four-point lead, 35.7 seconds left to go in the first half. And both teams with a timeout still. I mean, Spencer County with the opportunity to potentially try to get themselves in decent position. We've seen warm-ups from Tommy Childress out here kicking some long-distance type of stuff. And you never know. Maybe a play, two plays, something like that gets us into a spot where we could maybe put three on the board, or if we could break something to get six more. Either way, I don't see the Spencer County team laying down before they go into half.
Ethan Hampton back deep for the Bears. Short kick, fielded by Marksbury. Catches it at the 26. Tries to weave his way through. Gets across the 35 to about the 36. And with 29 seconds left, Bears will take over first and 10.
And a lot of what we expect to see in these next 29 seconds, we're going to know with this first play. We're going to see what Coach Marksbury comes out with here. If he does want to try to attack deep, if he does want to try to work the sidelines to save some clock, try to save that timeout to get down the field, we're going to have an idea of just how much attack he has in this offense going in at halftime. And really, Bo, if we could put some points on the board in 29.1 seconds, that's a statement right there going into the locker room and something that will really get your guys juiced up.
Barron out wide to the near side. Handoff. Ethan Hampton gets across the 35, maybe gains a yard there, John. And that's probably
going to
do it.
That's going to do it, yeah. I don't see any urgency at all for using that timeout or getting another play in. I think that's going to get us to the half.
Yep. Coach is done.
So stay with us here going into halftime as the clock runs down. Spencer County up 12-8, but we will have Phillips.
All of our future.
He'll be waiting down here on the sidelines to have an interview with Coach Marksberry going into the half. And then I believe also he's going to have an interview with one of our favorites out here, Bo, at halftime, Mr. Camden Cox, going to meet with the principal down there.
We're not allowed to have favorites.
I'm being told we're not allowed to have favorites. So he's a good kid. We'll put it that way. But going to meet with Phillips down there to set a game day for an interview here during the halftime. And let's see. Let's go down to Phillips right now as he has Coach Marksberry.
All right, Coach, 12-8. Really good half. I mean, I feel like that's probably the pace you're wanting, right? Like I feel like I watched the Spencer County football game in the first half.
We were doing what we wanted to do. And then we had a play. We were going to run on a two-point conversion. They came over. They called a timeout. We came over, and I let them talk me out of what we were going to do and go back to the one we ran the first time, and they were ready for it. But, we were fine. But what happened was then we let a mistake – and then all of a sudden we let our guard down and just let them take the ball and drive it 50 yards down the field and score on us. And, I mean, just those are things that you got to be mentally tougher than that and just say, you know, just keep playing the defense you were playing. And we let one guy bounce a run and get it down there. But now we'll be – they're playing – look, they're doing everything we ask them to do. They're playing hard.
The defensive half, I mean, a scoop and score, I mean, that's got to be huge.
It was a good half. It was a good half.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Coach. We appreciate you. So, at the half, here at the Doherty's Body Shop and Service Center Game of the Week, Spencer County 12, Fairdale 8. We'll be right back here on GHP Sports.
Dryer Vent Squad of Louisville reminds you that clogged or restricted dryer vents are the primary cause of dryer vent fires. Have your dryer exhaust vents inspected and cleaned by a professional at least once a year. Presented by the Dryer Vent Squad of Louisville. Dryer vent cleaning, rerouting, and repairing. Stay safe, save money, and time. 502-712-0333. DryerVentSquad.com. Dryer Vent Squad, we get the lint out.
Country Mart in Taylorsville has the finest selection of freshly butchered meats, produce, and all of the other ingredients to make your mealtime a victory. If you're running short on time or just don't feel like cooking, Country Mart is the only place in Taylorsville to get delicious Champs chicken. Dine in or take it to go. Your family will love it. Make sure to use your Country Mart card to save on food and earn points at the pump. Country Mart, your local grocery. Proudly serving Taylorsville and all of Spencer County for over 50 years.
We're going to talk a little football. Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. We'd like to welcome you to the halftime show. I'm Mr. Michael Phillips. I got to recruit Camden Cox to come and hang out with me for a minute, do a little student spotlight.
Yeah.
This kid right here, I hope people know how valuable this kid is to our building. If we had 100 Cam Coxes, we would have a great building. We do. But this kid right here, he leads the student section every week. He is a pretty decent basketball player that we'll talk about here in a minute. But Cam, tell me why so much school spirit, man? Well, like seriously, because you're not just out here on Friday nights doing this. This is a every day, 7 a.m. He is an office aide with us first period. He comes in fired up, ready to go every morning. Where's that come from?
Well, I like that you brag on me, but
and I don't want to be that guy who, you know, doesn't accept the compliment well, but we have a great student section in general. Like, we have amazing people everywhere. I mean, Miranda, Kaylin Stewart. I mean, we have people who show up all the time with high energy. So if they're going to give energy, you know, to our boys and to me when I play basketball, then I got to give energy back to them. And I love it here. I mean, we have great teachers, great administration. We have great everything going on. So, I mean, it's easy.
It was pretty cool the other night. I came to the soccer game, and we had like 30 or 35 kids in the student section. Oh, yeah. And then y'all got out at halftime and played soccer. Y'all should have thought about playing a little soccer in high school after watching that.
I wish GHP was there to catch my header at halftime. It was awesome. I mean, it was Messi-esque, but and you just said it. Like, we had 30, 40 people. It's not just me. We have a great student section in general. So.
We do. A couple weeks ago, we went to Collins. I heard a rumor that did you drive to Collins?
Oh, absolutely.
Did you? I heard you might have taken some kids, maybe that you might not necessarily know, or is that true? Did some kids not have a ride and you just let them jump in with you?
We had one new kid, Isaac, and he's come in very well, and we're an accepting school in general, so he's found his stride. So I said, hey, tomorrow you're going to the football game. So I took him. I took Levi. I took some kids that otherwise relationship based, sure, I wouldn't get to know.
That stuff's contagious, man. And when you leave here, you're going to leave that footprint on this building. All right, let's talk a little football real quick.
Oh, heck yeah. Let's go.
I know Cam comes in every week. Man, when we going to win? We got to win the game. He's about wins and losses a little bit. So we're up 12-8 at the half here. I know you're up there getting everybody rallied up, but what'd you see there? Like, what are we seeing? Because we had such a good year last year, and we would score, it felt like, 50 a game pretty easy. We're struggling offensively a little bit right now.
Well, I think the biggest thing is just going from like the Cam Cardwells, the Gabes, the Michael Collins, and having all that energy all the time to kind of Kellen, Drew, Connor, and Nick Stowe, leaders who aren't as vocal. It's a big change, and I think we're still finding our stride. And look, here's the thing we have to understand. We can go 5-5. If those five games we win are correct, we're number one going into playoffs. So it's not that big of a deal. Right now, I wish y'all could have seen it. I think we had about three rows fall down when we recovered that football for a touchdown. I think we're in a great situation right now. We've got
scores. Those are always nice. Momentum for the defense.
Absolutely. It seems like Spencer County football is coming back.
For sure. And it never really went anywhere. We had so many parts to replace. So many, not just on the field, but off the field. A lot of those senior leaders for us, we missed the Bryce Rourkes and all those kids that we don't want to start naming them because we'll leave one out. They've gone on. A lot of them are going on playing college ball and things like that.
Oh, yeah.
Our schedule was a little bit front-loaded, right? Yeah. So 0-3. I know people keep saying, oh, we're 0-3, but, man, like – That South Oldham team last week, that was about the biggest football. That looked like a Saturday college line.
It really
looked like a college football line.
Yeah, I think previewing that game, everybody kind of knew we had our hands full. And we've always kind of struggled with size, but, again, it's our third game. We just need to be ready to go by November.
I always say it when basketball, very rarely do we win the layup line, right? Like, we always look like we're undersized. We always look like, but, man, we're so prepared, So let's shift to basketball a little bit before we talk about the layup line.
Let's do it.
So we're not far from starting your senior year, right?
It seems like forever.
I know, and it feel like you've only been here for the blink of an eye, but give me y'all doing a little bit right now, just off-season stuff. What are you seeing?
Well, I don't want to, give too much away about that. We had a really, really good summer. We had a great finish to our summer ball. And, I mean, we have a really good team. I mean, sky's really the limit. I think everybody in the locker room, everybody around kind of sees that we can do something really special. And I believe that every year. But this year, being in my senior year, having the guys with me, my teammates, my class, I think we're going to go really far. I expect to be playing in March.
Coach Burns told me the other day that we're not going to shoot any threes this year. Is that true?
Yeah, no, we're definitely stepping away from that. Absolutely not. We got too many shooters. We've been doing this for too long. We got to stay out there.
And it's good. You got Luke Earhart and you got Kellen. Y'all are going to be kind of senior top heavy too a little bit,
So
I think the beginning of the year, pulling up some of them younger kids and getting them some minutes could be really, really vital as we get down into January and February and come district tournament time, because they're going to have to provide, right?
Yeah. And you mentioned that those three senior starters that are, ready to go, but I mean, Drew and Keaton, they're ready to go.
Keaton,
absolutely.
Yeah, so
Jack Armstrong, Brady Smith, Jackson Combs, I mean, Carter Walters, Adam Medley. These are guys who are going to come off the bench and they're going to contribute right away as soon as the season starts, as soon as they come off the bench. We have a really, really deep, really, really talented team.
Can we I don't know how much time we got left, so I want to just one last thing. I want to plug the Digital Den real quick, man. This is something these podcasting and newscasting we're doing every day. Just talk just a second about that.
Let's do it. Okay, so we have two classes dedicated to this. It's our new podcast media team. We're bringing you all the news. This guy gets
Love
on
it.
There weekly. Coach gets on there weekly. I mean, we give everything. So go check us out. SCHS Digital Den on YouTube. SCHS.digitalden on Instagram.
Good stuff.
Give us a follow.
Cameron Cox, I appreciate you, brother. Thank you for everything you do for us and our
go
business,
Bears.
Man. That's right. All right, Charlie, and Bo, John, back to you all. We'll finish up halftime, and I got a feeling we're going to win this ball game.
All right, we appreciate that.
We'll be right back here on GHP Sports.
What a tool. He could hit a gas line.
Wait, he's contacting 811.
They'll mark the underground utilities free.
Turns out he is smarter than he looks.
Know what's below 811 before you dig.
Are you looking for a reputable shop to take care of your ride? Stop by Dougherty's Body Shop and Service Center, offering all manner of body and mechanical work to keep your vehicle looking and performing at its best. Conveniently located at 910 Taylorsville Road in Taylorsville, or find us on the web at Dougherty'sBodyShop.com. Dougherty's Body Shop and Service Center. Big or small, we fix it all.
Welcome back to Spencer County High School. Here's our Dryer Vent Squad halftime show. John, appreciate Mr. Phillips and Cam Cox. Cam's always willing to jump in and do anything anybody asks of him.
Oh, he is.
Even
he
bring
is.
Us pork chop sandwiches.
He has, which I don't know if you're trying to lay down a hint or not about those pork chop sandwiches, but, you know.
Just saying. Welcome all of our future Bears.
Spencer County leads
here
at the half, 12-8, John.
Let's make some noise for
Spencer
these
County
guys.
Did have a couple really good drives, turnovers for each team. It kind of hurt, but had one really good drive, go down the field and score. Then you had the scoop and score on the turnover where Tanner Shuler took it about 40 yards, John, when he picked the ball up, took it down for the score, and then Fairdale scoring there late. Xavier Burks punching that ball in the end zone. They go for two and didn't get it. So that gets us to our score of 12-8. We got a few stats here for you. For Fairdale first, you got quarterback Myers. He's 2-4, 17 yards. Xavier Burks, which we knew this Burks-Washington combination, John, was going to be something that's going to be tough for Spencer County to stop. Burks, 9 rushes for 73 yards. Washington, 5 for 21. And for Spencer County, Jarrett Stewart, 1-4 for 7 yards. Kellen with 9 carries for 54 yards. Danny Armstrong, 3 for 12. Brody Phelps stepped up, 4 rushes for 24 yards for the Bears. And as far as team stats go, it looks like the Bears are 109 yards of offense in that first half. 2 penalties, John. The one face mask there late really set up that touchdown.
It did.
For the Bulldogs. And for Fairdale, they are just over 100 yards also. So it's kind of what we talked about in the pregame, Joe. John, low scoring affair, 12-8, kind of where we thought this game was going to be, because both these offenses really kind of struggling. I mean, they do have a good running game, but the one runs, the scores they got last week was broken plays, big plays.
Yeah.
During that game with Eastern and Spencer County, of course, we've documented well their struggles moving the football. But tonight, they went back to their identity of trying to run the football first, and that's really helped out.
Yeah, and I tell you, one thing that I really appreciate about the Spencer County defense so far in this game, Bo, you mentioned 17 yards passing is all Fairdale has. And we talked about that before the game started on how – if I'm a defensive coordinator, but I'm sorry, we just had a little technical difficulty coming through. But, back to what we were talking about, though, Bo, you said earlier, 17 yards passing for the Fairdale Bulldogs, which is showing just what you and I had mentioned in pregame. They're not a strong passing team. And then looking at the rushing totals where you mentioned 73 yards for Burks, Burks averaging 126 a game. So he's a little above average at halftime for what he would normally have. And so it's definitely something that Coach Eldridge and the Spencer County defense going to have to pay a little bit more attention to Six. Now, I'm not taking anything away from Six, because Burks himself, great hard runner. I mean, what he's been able to do, a lot of yards after contact, but Spencer County need to find a way to slow him down a little bit. But then the opposite side of that two-headed dragon, that is the rushing attack for the Bulldogs with Leedrick Washington, 21 yards And he's averaging 81.5 yards a game. So Spencer County doing a great job against him, holding him back to about a quarter of what he normally has in the entirety of the game. And so if they can continue, keep him from hurting them too much on the outside, breakaway speed or anything like that, and then keep Burks from being able to get these rushes between the tackles to where he's really just dealing with heavy contact, carrying 3, 4, 5 guys, getting the offensive line, helping to push downfield and everything, pick up those extra yards. Slow that down, and once again, just like we were talking about before, force this Fairdale Bulldog offense to beat you through the air. 17 yards in the first half, Bo. I don't think they could pull it off in the second half if you make them throw the football.
You know, it's kind of like we talked about that during the Collins game. You want to make Kay Gooden beat you as a quarterback and not a running back, and it's kind of the same way here with Fairdale. Not individually one person, but as a team. You want to make them beat you throwing the football and not running the football. And the Bears' defense has been stingy so far, and this they give up that one drive. Like I said, had some help from a penalty, but they give up that one drive, but they played well enough so far in the first half to win a football game, and that's exactly what we've seen through now the first 3.5 games of the season.
And regularly saying names like Stowe, Carnes, Biller, Blanford, these guys that are getting in on all these tackles in the middle, even getting a lot of tackles for losses for the Spencer County Bear, where they're getting that penetration at the defensive line. So important to get that pressure against Fairdale. We've seen already with the scoop and score just how much that can affect that quarterback and that backfield for the Fairdale Bulldogs. When you get that pressure deep in the backfield, they're going to make mistakes, and you're going to be able to capitalize on those mistakes, just like we were with Tanner Shuler with the scoop and score for 6.
I'm really impressed with this Spencer County offensive line. We've noted the size of the Bulldogs and their linemen. Spencer County's been able to open up those holes, John. You mentioned one earlier, big enough for me and you to go through. I mean, that's a big hole.
That's a big hole.
So, our offensive line is definitely doing their job. We've seen Tanner Shuler come out here and pull and put a great block on a guy to spring Marksbury free on a run around this right side. You see the wideout. You see Drew Barron down the field blocking on another play down there. And that's something, again, and I keep going back to this, getting back to the identity of Spencer County football. If it's 3 yards in a cloud of dust, I'll take that all day long.
I will too. And not to take away anything from Jarrett Stewart and what he brings to the game as a quarterback and what he's able to do passing. You know, this is an opportunity that Spencer County has right here to continue to show what their identity is, to continue to want to run the football, control the clock. But then when you have that quarterback and you have those receivers out there, Eric Henry, you have Kellen Marksbury, Drew Barron, going downfield, you just open up a whole nother level to that offense and a whole nother list of opportunities that you can take care of. And I tell you what, Bo, it's not just great for our offense, but it's headaches for a defensive coordinator for Fairdale to prepare for everything like that, to try to get his guys in position when he knows we're usually going to run the ball, but if he sells out on that, we are going to hurt him with Jared Stewart's arm. As we tick down here, both teams huddled up now, preparing for the opening kickoff of the second half. Again, Fairdale will receive this kickoff.
Bears meeting out in the field. So we got about 40 seconds here before kickoff. John Bears is just now breaking a huddle out on the field. Tommy Childress will be kicking off to the Bulldogs to start this second half. And if I'm Coach Marksbury, I want to see more of what we've seen in the first half.
Exactly. I want to do more of the defense being able to get the penetration they have, slow that running game down from Burke, continue to do what they're doing to Dedrick Washington, but then also just force this team to throw the ball. They're not an accurate passing team with a backup quarterback out there. You keep this team behind the sticks, and that rushing attack is going to have a hard time picking up first downs, and it's going to give the Spencer County Bears more possessions, be able to control the clock, work their way with their running game, maybe throw a few over the middle if they catch a safety cheating up, and come away with a victory.
And the second half is underway. Childress puts the boot to it. Ball fielded at about the 2-yard line. Washington, no, it's not Washington this time. Returns the ball to the left side. Makes a man miss. Gets across the 35 down to about the 36-yard line. Kwame Anderson returning that kick for the Bulldogs. And they'll start. Going to mark him at the 35.
Had a 32-yard return on that kick. I'm sure that's something Spencer County won't be exactly thrilled with when you're looking back at film, the coverage not being able to get down there to be able to try to put a lot of pressure on that return. But still, we're bringing back a potent Bears defense out on the field right now to set the tone for this second half.
Bulldogs break the huddle. One wide out either way. Pistol formation. Myers from the shotgun. Handoff. Washington tries to break it outside. Met just past the line of scrimmage. He's going to pick up about 2, maybe 3 on that play.
Yeah, they're going to mark him about the 39-yard line, I believe. Give him a gain of 4.
Second down 6 for the Bulldogs. Both these teams, John, love to run the football. So that's one thing you got to look at, too. There could be limited possessions in this second half because the clock's going to continue to run.
Yeah, it's definitely going to shorten the game up. I actually made a note of that after the first quarter, just how fast that first quarter went.
And off again to Washington. This time he gets around the right side. Ethan Hampton gets the tackle, but not before Washington picks up the first down for the Bulldogs. Gets out close to midfield. They're going to mark him at their own 47-yard line.
Yeah, Spencer County having a hard time on that side over there. Got to be able to get off your blocks, try to set that edge. If you allow yourself to get sucked into the middle as they peel those blockers around to the outside, you're going to have a difficult time making a stop on that play and able to pick up those 7 yards right there for the first down.
Trips. Or one wide out either way. Hand off again. This time Burks. He breaks free, and he's got a lot of room. Marksbury trying to chase him down at the goal line into the end zone. Touchdown, Bulldogs. We've got a flag late.
We're going to see if the touchdown stands here. Touchdown stands, dead ball, personal foul on Fairdale.
I'm not sure, but I believe that may have been Battle doing something with Kyle Brentzel on the sideline, who's just over here practicing kicking.
It may have been. Nonetheless, the touchdown stands. Put us at 14-12. Fairdale going to come out and I believe attempt the PAT. Yep. Try to give themselves a 3-point lead. And I'm sure that 15 yards is going to be taken by the Bears on the kickoff.
Dylan Walker, the kick is up. And it is good with 10:21 left to go in the third quarter. Fairdale 15, Spencer County 12, as we look at the Country Mart instant replay.
Again, Burke just a handful and a great job by the offensive line.
Got a hold here.
Being able to get some of their blocks, makes a man miss. And then really, Marksbury, the only person on the field right now with the speed to be able to match Burke to try to make that stop. And let's see if we see this personal foul right here. I think it was a more of a taunt type of a situation, yeah. I believe, on number four on the sidelines. Nonetheless,
honestly, don't know if I even agree with that call.
Yeah, I know. But nonetheless, it's still it's going to back up the Fairdale Bulldogs, where they're going to have to kick off from the 25-yard line instead of the 40, potentially giving Spencer County some great field position here to start this next possession.
Ethan Hampton back deep for the Bears. Standing about the 31-yard line. Ball's going. Bears got to pick that up. Fielded at the 12.
Brady good block. Smith good block.
Gets out of the lane. Going to get up to about the 40-yard line. Good return. Couple blocks there. Keenan Carnes in with a good block on that also, John. It could have been disastrous there for the Bears. It looks like they've got some good field position. See our Country Mart instant replay here.
There it was. Keenan just being able to clip that guy just enough, slow him down. Smith be able to get further upfield.
30-yard return.
Yeah, good field position, too, for the Bears.
Bears will start first and 10. They're on 42-yard line.
Important that Spencer County answers that touchdown scored by Fairdale right here. You cannot allow a team like that to be able to gain momentum on you.
Armstrong up the middle. Got a little room across midfield. Breaks it off to the right side. Going to go out of bounds about the 40-yard line. Pickup of 18 on the play.
By number two, Danny Armstrong. And that's good for another.
Watch this hole that gets blown open here. Is the lineman able to block down? 25 finds himself in no man's land for Fairdale, just kind of coming upfield to set an edge. Used to seeing a lot of sweep action coming along down the line, and when Spencer County able to hand that ball up to the middle, it's a great weapon to have if you're Spencer County. You keep defenses honest by doing that, and then that allows for in the future this defensive end 25 in that situation to want to crash down versus trying to block.
Go again to Armstrong. A lot of room up the middle across the 25. To about the 24-yard line.
Another
15-yard pickup.
So we see this again. Again, offensive line blowing holes open, getting up to that second level. That's key right there. As you see Connor Lawson come up and take out number 19, Elijah Faulkner, there at linebacker, and just pancaked him to be able to take him out of the play. Danny Armstrong running up the middle. Good visions, getting his read, getting good yardage. Bears first down.
10-yard pickup by Armstrong on that. First and 10, Bears. Bulldog 24-yard line. Stewart surveys the defense under center. And off again goes to Armstrong. Gets caught from behind. Almost looked like his head got pulled around there, John. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. May have picked up a yard.
Well, that's a situation you run it till they show they can stop it, you know, and I don't blame them right there. You get that focus there. You keep that focus on that fullback, getting that handoff, running up the middle, running between tackles, and that's going to take focus away from the outside. That's going to take focus away from the sweeps. That's going to take focus away from the potential of the passing game. You get those eyes looking at the middle, and that's when you can explode on the outside or even take a shot.
Second nine. And off again to Armstrong. Gets across the 20, down to about the 19. We'll mark him at the 20.
And that carry drives the Bears up to the 20.
Pick up
line.
A four. Bring up third and five.
Third and six.
Big play here for the Bears. You want to keep this drive alive after Fairdale. Able to have that big run by Burks to be able to get down, score that 6 points. This is your opportunity to answer. got to be able to put points on the board, keep that momentum for the boys in blue, and get your defense back out there and shut them down again.
Hand up by the official. Might see a timeout here by the Bears.
5 seconds.
Official starts to count. Timeout, Marksbury.
Not happy at all with the clock management there by his offense. Looking at his quarterback, wondering why. You got to be able to see that back judge. For folks at home watching this game, you see that back judge back there. He puts his hand up. It's 10 seconds. As soon as that hand goes up, it's 10 seconds on the play clock. And when that hand comes down and he starts waving that arm, it's a second each wave. You got 5 seconds left to go. Jarrett Stewart not seeing that and forcing Coach Marksbury to burn a timeout early in this second half. This student section down in front of us, this is great. Entertaining is, I mean, goodness, if we can get a shot of that going on right now, I don't know if we can or not, but man, they're having a good time down there. Again, construction night.
Love to see it, man.
I do too.
There was a long time you go to high school sports, there would be nobody there, and now it seems like it's all coming back around to the way it was when I was in high school.
This is the place to be on Friday night in Taylorsville. Close all the businesses, lock the doors, turn the lights out, and come down to the stadium. This is great.
Third and six. Stewart, handoff again. Armstrong is going to get forward to about the 16.
I think so. They're about the 17, 16-ish. Going to leave a fourth down and a tough decision for Coach Marksbury right here. Smith's going to come on the field. Hampton's coming off.
Looks like they're going for it. And they are. Big possession right here, John. Big play.
Fourth and three.
Pitch to Marksbury. Reverses field. Tries to come back around. Now he's in trouble. He's going to go down. Loss of about 12 on that play. Turnover on downs for the Bears.
Yeah, I don't think anybody was fooled on that Fairdale defense.
Fairdale takes over.
Set up Danny Armstrong off to the right side. As soon as Kellen Marksbury went into motion to the strong side of the offensive formation, Fairdale flowing that way, being able to come upfield. Great job by their defenders as well, staying home on the backside, making it to where he couldn't get that cutback to pick up that. Turnover on downs be Fairdale ball.
Bulldogs from the pistol formation. Handoff, big hole. Tackled from behind, Keenan Carnes grabbed him by the shoelaces, John, or he may have gone for more.
Okay,
going to pick up about seven.
Yeah, to have been a fly on the wall in halftime for these Fairdale Bulldogs and listening to what the coaches were saying to their offensive line. Their offensive line really struggled in that first half to be able to make holes, but
Look at this hole here, John.
Yeah, I mean, just massive and how they're getting leverage on the defensive line, where during the first half, Spencer County kind of owned those trenches.
This time hit at the line of scrimmage.
Hit and held on to by Nick Stowe. We'll bring up third and short, about third and two, I believe.
Third and two.
Just over halfway through this third quarter. Trips out to the right. Myers from the gun. Hand off to Burke. Burke gets enough for the first down. Going to pick up about four on that play.
Well, we got 75s hurt.
Carry Maine to the Bulldogs 42. First down.
Yeah, 75, Jesse Taylor. Tackle for this Fairdale Bulldog offensive line. Definitely in some pain down there.
We're going to take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back with our Daugherty's Body Shop Service Center Game of the Week. Your score, Fairdale 15, Spencer County 12. Be right back on GHP Sports.
Are you looking for a reputable shop to take care of your ride? Stop by Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center, offering all manner of body and mechanical work to keep your vehicle looking and performing at its best. Conveniently located at 910 Taylorsville Road in Taylorsville, or find us on the web at Daugherty'sBodyShop.com. Daugherty's Body Shop and Service Center, big or small, we fix it all.
Welcome back to Spencer County High School, our Daugherty's Body Shop Service Center Game of the Week. Jesse Taylor there, John, not putting any weight on that leg. Wish him the best.
Yeah, I feel bad for him right there. Was just talking about how being in the locker room with Fairdale at halftime and what they had, must have said to their offensive linemen to get the spark they had to open the holes that they have, and then to take a shot like that, emotionally, physically, losing a leader like that on the offensive line. You got to look to see how the Bulldogs are going to respond.
Washington hit at the line of scrimmage, taken down, picks up a yard.
Short gain on the carry. Second.
Jacob Blanzett in on that tackle, along with many others.
Yeah, short gain on that. It's going to be about a two-yard gain. Going to spot the ball at the 45-yard line of Fairdale. Second and eight.
On out wide each way. Pass, screen pass, out to the flat.
And not fooled.
Battle.
Not fooled at all.
Maybe a pickup of one on that, John.
Kellen Marksberry coming up quick from his corner position to be able to make the initial contact to slow him down. Of course, had others come in, filling in from the backside. I believe Keenan Carnes even in over there on that tackle, as well as Paxton Truitt coming up to clean that up. But still, Kellen Marksberry not fooled. Third down and eight, and we'd mentioned this. This is a difficult down for a team like this. They've been successful with Burke running the football, but it's awful hard to lean on that running attack when you're a third down with 8 yards to go.
Trips this time to the left.
Flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
Come from the back, Judge. You're going to have a delay of game called. We're going to make it third.
Up five more.
Yeah, third and even longer. We'll go from a third and about seven, eight, you know, long seven, to where now we're looking about a third and 13, 12 and a half to 13.
Three and a half minutes left to go in the third. Bears trail by three. Again, three out wide to the left for the Bulldogs.
Coach is out on the field for Fairdale. Dover coming out, not liking that. Going to call a timeout and talk this
timeout
over.
Taken by the Bulldogs.
Big third down here for the Fairdale Bulldogs. Big third down for the Spencer County Bears. When you got them backed up to where almost to their own 40-yard line, you're in a spot if you're Spencer County to try to force them to punt, potentially get the ball with decent field position. Plenty of clock left, obviously, only being in the third quarter, 3:14 left. And Spencer County still doing a pretty good job of moving the football. The last drive kind of sputtered out on him a little bit, tried to do a little bit with Kellen with that quick pitch on that fourth down to pick up the first down, but still in a spot with a lot of time left, some momentum still on their side, and a great opportunity here to get the football back.
Bears back out ready to go. Fairdale still in the huddle. Beautiful night for football, John.
It is. I love it.
Two out either wide either way. Myers looking to pass. Lefty bears back. Tries to go long. Overthrows his receiver. Kellen Marksburg, Paxton Druid in on the coverage there.
Yeah, double coverage downfield, making it difficult for the receiver to get open. Also, credit Nick Stowe coming up from the linebacker spot, getting some pressure on Myers, forcing him to throw that football off his back foot, making it really difficult for the receiver to be able to get under it right without that coverage being in his way. Fourth down, bringing up the punt here for Fairdale.
Marksburg standing on his own 25-yard line. Kick is up. Fair catch called. He'll field it at the 28-yard line.
Take over from their own 28, first and 10.
3:02 left to go in the third. First and 10 for the Bears. They're on 28.
So we're over a half, almost three-quarters of the way of football game over with Bo. And we had talked about in pregame and how they're just – seems to be a lack of a spark on the offense, and we've seen some glimpses of some great stuff happen, but man, it's almost like we need just a touch more. If we can get just a touch more out of this offense, try to get these wheels turning again, get that momentum back, get the emotion back on the offense, and it will seem like we're cooking with something.
Armstrong gets forward, going to get right just past the first down marker. That'll move the sticks up to the 40-yard line, pick up a 12. He's really been a spark here, John, in the second half.
He has. Danny Armstrong being able to work that middle. Again, the offensive line being able to do what they're doing. You see Connor Lawson getting up to Burks and being able to shove him off to the side as Danny Armstrong comes through. Great vision again by Armstrong. Follow his blockers. Get everything you can get. And first down, Spencer County.
Bears taking a little time here. Hand in the air by the official.
They need to hurry up.
Do get the playoff. Armstrong again across the 40 up to about the 43-yard line. Pick up a 3.
Okay,
make it second down and 7.
Second and 7.
Actually going to mark him at the 44. Pick up of 6.
We look here at the Country Mart instant replay. Again, just being able to hand the ball off to Danny and so many players watching what's going on. You even see Kellen Marksbury coming across. He throws his hands up. That's to fake him out. That's to try to make them think a pitch went over his head.
Armstrong again across midfield. Good enough for a first down.
Armstrong
into Fairdale territory up to about the 47, 48-yard line. Here again, see.
They're just running the same thing. That swing motion coming from Kellen Marksbury off of the left side of the formation, faking as if he's getting a pitch, handing it off to Danny Armstrong, and until they prove that they can stop it,
Stewart.
All
nowhere
kinds
to go.
Of time.
Throws it out to Ethan Hampton, dropped it.
Great protection offered to Stewart right there with the offensive line. Tip my hat to them in that situation.
Good check down there, too, also.
I know early in the season we got a chance to talk to Coach Marksbury, and he mentioned he had a new assistant on the staff with Coach Cressup coming down here. He had coached at Collins, been off a few years, called up Marksbury, was wanting to get back in the game, and just talked about how valuable he was at working with Jarrett Stewart. You know, during practice, pull him aside, work on reads, work on footwork, and what he's been able to bring to the table has been great.
Armstrong breaks free, gets across the 40, gets out of bounds. Going to be just short of the first down marker.
No, they marked him up to 35. That's first down. Yeah.
The official on the other side was up past the 40, John. I don't know what he was thinking.
And that's good for another.
Well, if he's a little closer to that 40-yard line, he's a little closer to those pork chops cooking over there on the grill at the concession stand. He's smelling that. That's kind of drawing him that way, not really helping us here. But, again, great run by Danny Armstrong. Way to stay behind his blocker. Hide. Do what he can to get himself in position, using that vision once again to get downfield. And Danny Armstrong been an incredible spark for these Bears.
Again, Armstrong up to about the 30-yard line. Pick up of about 5 on that play. Coach Marksbury's found something he's locked, John.
Yeah.
Hey, like you said earlier, you go to the well till they stop it.
Till they stop it. You keep working it. And 5 yards of carry, even if that's all we get out of Danny Armstrong, that moves the ball down the field, keeps those chains moving, and it's hard to lose if you're going to pick up around that 5 yards of carry type of a thing. We drop under 30 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. Could potentially be the last play of the quarter. Yeah,
Armstrong
that probably
gets up
will
to
be
about
the last one.
No original game, line of scrimmage, that'll be the last play. Your score at the end of three, Fairdale High School 15, Spencer County 12. We'll be right back with the Doherty's Body Shop and Service Center Game of the Week here on GHP Sports.
Curious what your home is worth? Visit brownrealty.com. Brown Realty, serving Spencer County and beyond for nearly 20 years. Brown Realty, your local realtor.
As we're back here at Spencer County High School, let's take a look. I want to see this formation that we had to last. Now, if we stop this right here and you look at where these defenders are lined up and you look at where Danny Armstrong was going to go, Danny actually looking to move to the A-gap, be the gap right beside the center, and you see defenders lined up in the A-gap, and it's a situation where Jarrett Stewart, as a quarterback, has to see that. He has to be able to recognize those guys lined up in the A-gap, and with the play that they're trying to run, check that off. Let's see if we can go ahead and run that play now. Our Country Mart instant replay, as they scoot up, they're moving up to guard that A-gap, and that's not the play I'm looking at right there. Yeah, I'm sorry. But that's the situation we had the last play
third
before.
Five. Armstrong moves forward to – he's going to be a couple yards short. And then we're back in this same situation, John, we was down here on the other side of the field late in the first half.
We are.
Fourth and two.
Yeah, fourth and two, fourth and three. Decision time for the Bears. Not running out of clock yet, so it's not a spot where you, if you're Coach Marksbury, you're thinking, I've got to get at least three out of this in order to tie the game. But it's a spot where it's so important for the Bears to pick up this first down, keep this momentum going, keep this Bulldog defense on the field that's starting to wear out.
Marksbury goes in motion. Marksbury's going to burn a timeout here.
Yeah, they lined up, tried to see if they could get the Bulldogs to jump offside. Very disciplined by that defensive line to be able to wait. Try to see if the ball would move, and they set on it, Bo. It's a great job, well coached by the defensive line coach. But still at a spot where sitting at fourth and a long two, fourth and three type of situation to where if you're Coach Marksbury, you've got to find a way to pick up this yardage. I mean, if we ended up kicking a field goal from here, we would be looking at around, see where at the 27, so about a 44-yard field goal attempt. And Tommy Childress has a leg. We've seen it. Okay, we're going to bring up that replay of that last play. And here, that's just what I'm talking about, where they're lined up in the A-gap. I believe that's Burke. They're not Burke. That's
Mackay Smith, Duncan.
Yeah, lined up in that A-gap. And where he's sitting right off to the left side of the center for Spencer County. That's something where Jarrett Stewart needs to see that. That's where that ball's going. And when he's already lined up in that gap, you're going to have a very difficult time trying to run that. So you've got to be able to see that, check that off, and they're just going to come up and fill, and you're not going to have what you need out of that.
Pitch to Marksbury. Tries to get around the left edge. He slips, and he's not going to get it.
We do have a late flag on the play.
Phillips, are you down there? Can you see that?
Up. It's after the play, so the play is going to stand, and they're going to get 15 yards, I believe, after the play. I think, but I don't know.
Dead ball. It's a dead ball. Personal foul. Yeah. So, yeah, that's what's going to happen. Even though you have a flag on a play like that, the play was over when the penalty occurred. Once that play is over, and in a situation like that on fourth down where we hadn't picked up that first down yet, the ball then goes to Fairdale, and then you mark the penalty off. Once again, Spencer County going to look to their defense, try to make a stand here, try to get themselves back in good field position to be able to get a drive and get a score here before the end of this game. 11 minutes left to go, and Bo, you predicted it, low-scoring affair.
Yeah. Hand off, Washington up the middle, gets across the 15 to about the 16-yard line, maybe pick up a half a yard to a yard there. He's second down and nine.
Second and nine.
Clock continues to run. 10.5 minutes left to go in the game. Bears trail by three. And off this time to Burke. Met in the backfield.
Good stand there by the defense from Spencer County Bears.
Going to give him the line of scrimmage. So it'd be about third and nine.
Nick Stowe once again getting up from that pile. Big third down right here. Spencer County needing this stop. This is not only an opportunity to get the ball back, but this is an opportunity to get the ball back with good field position. After that 15-yard penalty at the end of that fourth down play for Spencer County, really backing up Fairdale, you got to take advantage of that field position and how deep they've been buried to give yourself a good spot to start the next possession.
Trips out to the left. Myers looks to pass. The lefty throws. Overthrows his receiver. Incomplete. That'll bring up fourth and eight.
We do have a flag on the field, though. We're going to have a holding on the offense. That penalty will be declined, which is going to force a punting situation for the Bulldogs. Here we got the Country Mart Instant Replay where you'll get a chance to see that holding.
Another flag on the play before we even start. I don't know. It's on the Fairdale side of the field. This is not anything to do with football here, John.
This is definitely after the play. We got the official out here. Let's see what he has. Of course, it's a dead ball. Personal foul. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Fairdale Bulldogs. Going to back them up a little bit more. And once again, trying to give the Bears a little bit better field position here. Kellen Marksbury back deep. He's about the 43-yard line to receive the punt.
Punt short.
Oh, it's a bad punt. Fairdale bounce.
I ain't so sure that didn't hit Brody Phelps on the foot.
Spencer County going to take over at the Fairdale 47. So Spencer County with good field position. And Bo, really moving the ball pretty well. Danny Armstrong, been a spark like you mentioned, but finding themselves every once in a while in that spot where they're ending up with a third and medium type of situation, not able to pick up the first down. And there, Danny Armstrong just shut down. Stopped in there by Cameron Ross.
Short loss on the carry. Second and 11.
Yeah, we were worried about that ball possibly hitting Smith. Of course, if it had, the officials didn't see it, but the ball yard or two away from him from our angle can be a little difficult to see sometimes.
Second and 12. Stewart looks to pass. Now he's going to tuck it and go. Gets pulled down from behind. May get up to the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be just short of it, maybe about a yard. Pickup of one. Bring up third and 11.
Short gain on the play.
And these are those positions that we've put ourselves in these last few drives to where we're third and medium to third and long, and the Bears having a difficult time converting those third downs and then making a decision for fourth down and just not successful at all. So far, 0 for 2 on fourth down conversions for the Spencer County Bears tonight.
Stewart hobbling a little bit after that play. First comes back. Marksburg makes a man miss. He's got room.
He's
going to go to the house.
Touchdown, Bears!
Number three. 48-yard run by Kellen Marksbury. Puts the Bears out front with 7:51 left to go in the ballgame.
Great run. The Bears needed that. Kellen Marksbury needed that run. Needed to have that success to be able to do something. Reverse, just a great call there. So much of the offense so far this game has revolved around that original motion, revolved around what the defense is first going to see. And we'll end up seeing a replay here after this kick.
Kick by Brentzel is up and good, and with 7:51 left to go in the ballgame, Spencer County 19, Fairdale 15.
But let's watch this Country Mart Instant Replay. Watch this defense bite off of the first motion. They're going to move with that initial to Ethan Hampton, that handoff, and that cutback by Kellen Marksbury, the block sealed off by Eric Henry to be able to make that hole. And, Bo, you'll be hard-pressed to find somebody else on the field with the speed in the open field that Kellen Marksbury has, just able to open it up, put it in the high gear, and in the end zone for six.
That's got the fans down here below us, John, fired up again.
.751 left to go in the game. Spencer County with a four-point lead. Defense coming up big on that last drive, Bo. Can get another stop here, be able to get the football, work that clock, work that running game. Spencer County in the driver's seat right now. As the ball falls off the tee here, Childress going to have to reset it.
Like to see him put one deep right here, John, back in that coffin corner.
Oh, yeah.
Straight
nice
away.
Kick. Nice kick.
Ball's going to go into the end zone for a touchback. Bulldogs will get the ball at the 20.
Now we're seeing the Spencer County Bears defense in the second half, though, that we really haven't had an opportunity to see a lot this year. Usually by the time we're getting to this point of the game, they've spent so much time on the field that they're exhausted. And now a defense going out there, getting plenty of chance to get a drink, catch their breath, go out and make another stop. And it's all because the offense has kind of found their way in this game. So credit that offense, that offensive line doing a great job in this game. Spencer County defense still firing on all cylinders, 7:51 left to go. And Bo, this is a good shot for the Bears.
Myers.
And nothing, nothing.
Washington
nothing.
Met in the backfield by host of Bears, Jacob Biller.
And Blanford. Ian Blanford. Both coming off their edges and just lighting him up. And I mean, again, names we've mentioned over and over again tonight. Let's look at the Country Mart instant replay. And here you can see Biller coming from this side, number 11.
Both ends.
I mean, they just crashed down on that run. And this is what we talked about when we were looking at this offense from this Bulldogs. It sets up like a read option type of thing, but you don't see the quarterback keep the ball. So they're able to crash down as soon as they see that handoff opportunity and try to get a good
screen
stop.
Pass. Man reverses field.
Just nowhere to go. Nowhere to go.
Coach Eldridge all the way down at the 10-yard line cheering on his defense.
Drew Barron staying home, be able to beat his blocker, be able to get that stop. Spencer County defense is fired up tonight. Let's look at the Country Mart instant replay here. And I mean, this is exactly what you want to see. Of course, our defense moving to the side, trying to be able to get that stop. But then Drew Barron recognizing the running back changing fields, coming back to this side as Malik Battle doing
sheds
all he could to try to get some yardage. But Drew Barron in position, shedding that blocker, able to make a great stop, backing him up, 3rd and 17 for the Bulldogs. And I think we're going to get a timeout. That's going to leave Fairdale with one timeout remaining. Spencer County also with one timeout remaining. 6:07 left to go. And as we're hearing, Phillips, we have you down there.
Yeah, it's totally a little different feel down here right now. You can tell it's funny how momentum is, once you get it on your side, it's the right time of the game to have the momentum for sure, because that Keller Marksberry run fired up this defense, and now they've, with a long stop here, they could get it right back in the offensive hands and maybe do a little something to close this game out.
We got to keep an eye here on Jared Stewart. He is over here hobbling on the sideline.
Yeah,
Jared Stewart went down kind of awkwardly on that time when he kept the football, and it doesn't take much. You get somebody tackling you from behind that can reach up and grab your legs and just kind of land a little bit on that ankle-foot area and just tweaks it a little bit. And it's very uncomfortable. It's nothing that can't be played through, but still something that we're going to pay attention to throughout the rest of this game. But once again, Spencer County defense, great opportunity here to get a big stop. Again, great opportunity to get good field position to close out this game with 6 minutes left to go.
Two out wide to the left, one to the right. Myers looks to throw. Tucks it.
Enough Nick there. Stowe. Nick Stowe. Nick Stowe.
Inside
Nick
the
five. Stowe.
Nick Stowe.
Takes down Myers inside the 5-yard line, John.
See where they mark it here.
Punter's going to have his.
They're going to mark it about the 9-yard line. They're going to give him forward progress for the quarterback, but still. Huge, huge play by Nick Stowe there, being able to get that sack. Backing the punter up into the end zone. Kellen Marksberry back deep, standing on about the 43-yard line to receive this punt. 5:22 and ticking left to go.
Punt going to go dead just into Fairdale territory, about the 48-yard line. Or Spencer County territory.
The Bears will take over from their own.
Let's see this sack here on the Country Mart instant replay.
Nick laying back. Now he's going when he sees that quarterback tuck.
That really a generous spot there by the officials, as Nick got a hold of him somewhere closer to the 7 or 8 yard line. But still, great job by him to come up. And not just a great job by him, you have to tip your hat to the secondary if you're in that spot. Quarterback Myers drops back. He's looking downfield, trying to find an open receiver. Receivers just locked down by corners and by safeties out there and making it to where there's nowhere to go. And Nick Stowe, a sure tackler that he is going to be able to get that sack when you give him that amount of time.
Stewart under center. Marksbury goes in motion, takes the pitch, comes around the short side, gets across midfield. It's going to go out of bounds about the 41-yard line. We're going to mark him at the 40.
It's going to be enough for a first down.
First down. Pick up a,
and that's good for another.
About 12 on the play. And this is exactly, John, the situation Coach Marksbury wants to be in. When you got a running game like the Bears, and they've been controlling the ball really in the second half with that running game, you can sit and chew this last 5 minutes off the clock.
Yeah, and that's how you want to do it. Of course, the only difference right there, you would like to see Kellen not go out of bounds and stop the clock on that, but still, picking up that first down, giving yourself a fresh set of downs, and again, controlling that clock, and I wouldn't mind seeing another score just to put a little cushion on the board.
Hand off to Armstrong. Covering both points of the ball, gets forward. Going to mark him just short of the 35-yard line.
Get about 3 yards, I believe, on the carry. Maybe pushing four, 3.5 yards. Bring about a 2nd and 7 for Spencer County.
The Bulldogs 36, 2nd and 7.
Clock continues to tick.
This is an opportunity if you're Spencer County to really make a statement for your season right now. This is a chance to have one of those drives that'll be remembered for a long time. If you can go down and punch this one in after all you've been through in these first three games and how you've struggled, even with a few mistakes in this game, but to say to the world, to say to this district that we're back on track, this is your chance.
Armstrong's going to get forward to about the 35, maybe pick up a yard. Bring up 3rd and 6.
And these are those ones that's been kind of uncomfortable, though.
The play.
These third and mediums have not been Spencer County's friend tonight. You still have a lot of options. You still have things you can do, whether it's running or throwing the ball. But credit the linebackers and the defensive line and the entire defense of Fairdale, really, to be able to lock down on these third and medium situations and be able to slow Spencer County down, making it difficult for them to convert third downs and putting them in those tough fourth down spots.
Marksbury comes around back, going to get hit from behind. They're going to lose a couple yards there.
A little bit of extracurriculars there after the play's over. Officials aren't going to throw a flag, but there were a few words said about settling down a little bit, I believe. As the clock continues to run, as we're 3:06 left to go in the ball game.
Marksbury with both teams with one timeout.
4th and 9.
He's been known to bring his team up the line of scrimmage here, John. I believe he's just going to run it down. He's talking to Coach Eldridge over here on the sideline, trying to figure out what they're going to do. They're definitely going to call the timeout.
Oh, yeah. Let
the clock run
as much clock as he can. Yep. I don't blame him here. There's no reason to take that timeout with you. That's what he's going to do. Run the clock down. 2:36 left to go in the game. Spencer County, 4th and 8.
You have to punt here.
And yeah, you're in a situation, if I'm Coach Marksbury, I'm punting the football. You know, if anything happens where you're not able to pick up this first down, if you go for it, you've given that Fairdale offense, who at times has had some success. They've broke some big plays. You cannot roll the dice like that knowing that they can pull off those plays. You have to be able to punt that deep, pin them deep. We got a defense that's fired up.
How do you not
stops.
Trust your defense at the way they played in
exactly.
the second half?
And that's it. The way they played, you trust them. You know you're going to have Blanford. You're going to have Biller, Carnes, Stowe, all these people that are coming in on that defense, and as pumped up as they are, this is the right call right here as Childress comes out on the field to punt.
Phillips?
Yeah, I think. If you're Coach Eldridge, you want him to punt, right? Like, you want your defense to win this game. That's
absolutely.
That's what they've done all game. So, I mean, if you get a decent punt here and you get them inside the 20, I'm going to take my chances on them going 80 yards. I think our defense stands.
Good no punt, end front. Over end. Bears going to let it roll.
Now that's going to roll dead about the five-yard line.
Couldn't ask for a better spot to put that ball from Tommy Childers.
Yeah, great job by Tommy. Tommy, the type of kicker that we've seen him go out here punting some footballs where he's punting at 60 or 70 yards. And to have that kind of control to be able to pooch punt that thing, roll it dead down inside the 10, down to the 5-yard line, giving the long field to the Fairdale Bulldogs with the Spencer County defense that Bo is just lighting up right now. And so I'm with Phillips. I'm with you even. I put this in the hands of my defense to let them win this game.
2:26 left to go. Bears lead by 4. Fairdale's got 95 yards. Two out wide to the left. Handoff. Up the middle. Caught from behind.
Nowhere to go.
Nick Stowe. They're going to take him down in the end zone, but they'll give him forward progress.
Yeah, they're going to say forward progress was stopped at the line of scrimmage, so that's where they'll bring the ball back to.
Second down and 10.
Yeah, as we see here, the defense gets a hold of him and drives. Really gave a favorable spot again for the 5-yard line. I think Nick Stowe had him wrapped up closer to the 4, but still, runner down before the ball would have been fumbled.
Myers passes out the flat, incomplete.
The quarterback, Myers, down on the ground. Keenan Carnes laying the lumber to him there right after he threw the football. He's hanging that arm as he's coming off to the sidelines. Going to bring up a 3rd and 10.
Clock does stop with the incomplete pass. Myers is going to tuck. He's going to run. He's going to get hit out of bounds. That's got to be close, man.
Oh, yeah. I have not seen a flag, but I'm glad I haven't seen a flag. They're going to give that as a sack.
Loss on the play.
Going to move the ball back to about the.
Got to be about the 1-yard line, don't it?
4th and 13.
On the 2.
Want to take this opportunity to remind everybody, stay with us after the game. We will have the Kelly Hubbick coaches interview, post-game interview. We will also have the Trevor Brown Construction player of the game interview. And, Bo, we've already had a few ideas. We'll kind of hold those cards close to our chest right now before we give that away.
Time out, Fairdale.
By the Bulldogs.
That's going to be the last time out of the game right there.
Coach Dover calling a timeout here, John, but he's got to go for this.
You have no other choice. What, you have nothing else to lose right here. Minute 33 left to go in the game. Whether you turn the ball over on downs, whether you pick up the first down, that's the only option you really have. You punt the ball, you know, with no timeouts, you can't stop that clock again. Spencer County would be able to kneel on the ball and end this game. No choice by the Bulldogs. Got to go for it. Spencer County look to see more of like a cover 4 type of a defense here where they're going to back up. They're going to give a little space underneath, but it's one of those you just don't let anybody get deeper than you if you're Spencer County secondary.
5 defensive backs in the game for the Bears. Got a stack over here on the right side. Looks to throw. Got a man open. Complete to Quan Brown. He falls at the 16-yard line.
And he's close to a first down.
He's
going to
be close. They're moving the chains.
They're going, but still, clock's got to move. Clock's moving. There's no timeouts. Did not get out of bounds. Minute 20 left to go. Is Fairdale a little confusion trying to get lined up here?
Trips out to the left. Myers from the gun. Should have been a flag. Not called. Screen pass.
That's a live ball. That's a live ball. Spencer County ball. And that's going to do it.
You throw that ball backwards, John. That's, right. That's what happens.
Backwards pass right there. That is a live football with the lateral. Spencer County jumping on it. Minute 3 left to go. Fairdale can do nothing now to stop this clock. Let's look at the Country Mart instant replay. You'll see this ball move backwards. 2 yards, 2 yards backwards. Live football. And I mean, just Fairdale, for what they've tried to do today, every effort that they've made to move the football on the ground, we already knew their passing attack wasn't that great. And, again, that's something that Coach Dover's going to have to go back to the drawing for the Bulldogs and see if he can work out another dimension for his offense to be able to move the football. But
Bears in victory formation. Stewart takes a knee to get the clock going.
He's going to have to do it one more time.
Stop the clock.
We need one more kneel down. One more kneel down.
Bears are going to pick up their first win of the season, John. 1-3, and then no better time to for your offense to start clicking a little bit and get going. You got district play starts next week at Franklin County, which is could be one of the toughest games left on our schedule. They're ranked top five.
And that's going to do it. That's going to do it as the offense comes back off the side of the field. Great victory for the Bears. A 5A Fairdale team coming in here. I know we already talked about they suffered some losses with injuries and things where they're still trying to find their way. But still, Spencer County, a notch in the win column for them. Maybe get a little momentum going. Offense showed some great things. Defense, incredible for this game for the Spencer County
especially
Bears.
In the second half. They played well the whole game, John, but the second half, they shut them down. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll have the Teacup postgame show. Spencer County wins 19-15 here on GHP Sports.
Hi, I'm Kelly Hubbick, and I have been a proud resident of Spencer County for nearly 15 years. As a local real estate agent, I am thrilled to be working with Brown Realty and assisting more of my neighbors and friends right here in Taylorsville with their real estate needs. I can think of no better place to put down roots, both professionally and personally, than in Spencer County. Our community sets itself apart from others in that it possesses a small-town atmosphere, in addition to residents who truly go above and beyond to help one another in whatever capacity necessary. Those traits, mixed with the genuine beauty of the county, make me honored to not only live and work here, but to raise my children here as well. In addition to real estate, I serve on the executive board for the Spencer County Taylorsville Chamber of Commerce, and I look forward to working with fellow business owners and residents of our community for years to come.
Welcome back to Spencer County High School. Victory for the Spencer County Bears, John. We got the Teacup postgame show. 19-15, Spencer County pulls out the win tonight, John. Defense, again, is the name of the game,
it
but
is.
They got back to doing what Spencer County football does, run the football for Coach Marchbury and his kids.
And it all starts up front. An offensive line that you and I had talked about multiple times this season, about how there was a lot of question marks, a lot of new guys involved with that offensive line, had to kind of step up to the learning curve. And what they were able to do tonight, controlling the trenches to be able to open up a lot of these holes, to be able to give opportunities to Danny Armstrong, Kellen Marksberry, Ethan Hampton, Smith, all these boys that carried the football, it was just incredible for them to be able to get that and be able to pull off this victory. And honestly, I hope the camera stays on what it's on right now because we need to see Coach Hall singing out here too, Bo, after the victory. So, Spencer County, just a great game, great job by the defense, a defense that we've known all season long has played well enough to win every game they've been involved with, but the offense able to move the football the way they were, give the defense plenty of an opportunity to rest, come out, make adjustments, and reset. But you know, just an awesome victory. Bo, do you have some stats for us there?
I do. I'm looking down through here. 19 first downs for the Spencer County Bears. Not 40 rushes, 227 yards. I made mention, I'm going to pat myself on the back.
Oh, yeah?
I made mention they got to get between 225 and 250 for the game. They got 227. That gives them the victory tonight. Jarrett Stewart, 1 of 5 in the game. 1 interception in that. 45 plays, 234 total yards for the Bears. For Fairdale, 17 first downs, 27 rushes for 155 yards.
They had 27 yards passing on 5 of 11. Three turnovers for the Bulldogs. And individually, Bears tonight with two 100-yard rushers.
And Coach Hall leading the singing out there.
Danny Armstrong, who, John, is going to be our Trevor Brown Construction Player of the Game today. 18 rushes, 101 yards for Danny. Kellen, 13 rushes for 100 yards. Brady Smith, 1 for 7. Ethan Hampton, 2 for 6. Jarrett Stewart, 2 for 3. Brody Phelps, 3 for 1. And we always... Danny had 19 for 101.
Yeah, that's what I thought you said. 101 yards, 19 carries, 101 yards. So averaging, I mean, just over 5 yards a carry for Danny.
Put the team on his back, John, really.
He really
especially
did.
The third quarter, but the whole second half. And really good showing for the Bears. Got the running game going again. It's exactly what they need.
Yeah, as we are patiently awaiting here, I know I'd see Danny and Coach Marksberry both making their way over to the game day setup where Phillips will have them for the Kelly Hubbard coaches interview and the Trevor Brown Construction Player of the Game as he gets them set up over there.
Hey, great job. Now look, 19 rushes, 101 yards. Man, are you tired?
Just a little bit.
Great game. Man, look, this was a game that we had to grind out, had to keep our offense on the field. They kept 19 carries. I can't remember a running back for us having 19 carries in a long time, to be honest with you. What was Coach saying in the huddle?
Just hold on to the ball, really, and just have faith in everybody on the line. And just really all it really was is just I couldn't have done it without that line. They were delivering the blocks I needed. They were doing everything I needed, and that was the only way I could do anything.
Just grinding out. These type of games, are they fun to play when it's that tight, or would you rather be in the 48-0 games? Which one do you prefer?
Oh, this is exceptional. I love this. This is great.
That's right. Great job, man. Player of the game. Hey, that's a win that we needed. You know that, right? Y'all been working hard. Coach said y'all had a good week of practice, so we're at Franklin County next week, right?
Yes, sir. We hope to do the same thing.
Show back up Monday morning, get to work, right?
Yes, sir. We hope to come with another win.
Thank you, Danny Armstrong. Great job. Good game. All right, we got Coach coming in here. All right, Coach. They got us a table. Can you believe this? I don't know. Like, they can hear us in the background and everything. All right, I'm gonna give you a mic, Coach. We're gonna try this out here.
All right,
19-15, Coach. Like I said at halftime, I felt like I watched a Spencer County football game. Like it was a grinded out, just not a quick hitting offense, but just did what we had to do. Just a great overall team win. I thought both sides of the ball played really well. I thought special teams played well. Like just a pretty good performance, you think?
Right. Yeah. I mean, it's just one of those things. You know, we got back to who we were. I think we really kind of got away from who we were, and we were trying to be something we weren't. Then when times get tough, when pressure gets on you and everything like that, you really don't know what you're going to fall back on. But that's who we are, and play good defense, kind of let our guard down. We had a miscue on special teams, and then our defense kind of let up there. But the defense played outstanding, sure. And our goal was to play good defense and score just enough points. And I can't answer that. I would much rather a 48-0 game, so I can answer
well,
that.
Well, Danny Armstrong said he liked these better. I don't know. But as a coach, I'm sure. But a scoop and score in the first half from your defense, right? And then, I don't know, a couple 2.5 minutes to go, fourth down. I couldn't help but notice, man, you had three or four coaches around you there that it looked like you were kind of – it was almost like it was a group decision to punt there and put that on your defense to kind of win the ball game there at the end.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, look, you can see Tommy's a weapon. We just the big thing was we just needed him to understand he was only like 42 yards away, and if he kicked it, he'd have kicked it on top of the complex over. Yeah. So we had to make sure that he understood that we needed him just to bunt it down there and let it roll out and not bang it into the end zone. He did exactly what he was supposed to do, and
That's who we are. We punted the ball and let our defense go out there and make a stop. And that's, you know, even when they got the first down to the 15-yard line, I mean, we were backing off and giving them that because we knew they had no timeouts. We just didn't want to let them double move us or double pass it or purple pass it or whatever they could do to get a big play on us.
How bad did we need this win?
The coach needed it really bad. You could just see you could just see how relaxed and, it's almost like letting the air out of a balloon. It was just a lot of pressure. I mean, look, they know the expectations with our program, and we had a tough three-game stretch, and we had some kids show up out here tonight and make some plays, and we took care of the football pretty well, and that's what we need to do, and that'll lead to some success.
Yeah. Winning on Friday nights probably makes Monday afternoon a little bit easier.
Yes, when you show back up
to start watching a little film.
Yeah, we'll get them in Monday and get started again. But look, their preparation from we practiced Labor Day morning, and from their preparation from Monday through Thursday was really good this week. A total different from what they had last week, and I knew that I kind of had a pretty good idea we were going to play well, and they answered a bell, and I'm really excited for them. Just the excitement, the student body too. I mean, they needed that too. They keep coming out here, and the crowd as a whole. I mean, we're an 0-3 football team. This place was packed tonight, so that's a good deal. It's hard
to keep up with all of it, man. Art, this community just drives a lot of what we do.
But. Yes.
All right, so let's fast forward 7 days. We're headed to Franklin County, right? Our first district game of the year.
Yes.
Good ball team. We know that it's who ended our season last year.
Right.
What are we looking at for preparation, and what can we expect?
Well, they're definitely the class of our district, and we just got to do what we did tonight. We just got to play good football and defense and try to scratch out a few first downs and figure out a way to score, maybe get a special team score, maybe get a defensive score. And look, they're going to be really tough, and it's going to be tough over there, and they had a week off, but the kids should bounce back from this, give them a little bit more juice on Monday, and we'll go over there and battle. And like I said, it's nobody's feeling sorry for us, so it's a pretty tough 5-game stretch, but we were glad to get this one tonight.
The last thing I got is I want to thank you, because I've been around sports since I can remember, and I don't know if there's anything better in sports than listening to Coach Hall at the end of a football game, end of a win. That's as good as it gets.
Yes, well, that's another thing. We needed the win so Coach Hall could sing with the kids, and that was had the whole student body out there and all the team and everything. That was pretty awesome.
It's good stuff, Coach. Well, we appreciate you. We know how hard you work. You're the best coach that I know, so I appreciate everything you do, man, and good win.
Thank you
very
much.
Go next week. Go Bears.
Go Bears.
Thank you, Phillips, and we appreciate Coach Marksberry there on our Kelly Hubbard coaches interview and our Danny Armstrong for the Trevor Brown Construction Player of the Game. John, again, can't say it enough. Bears got back to their identity, ran the football, come away with a victory tonight when they sorely needed something to go in the win column, especially you got your next 5 weeks are all district games, and it's going to shape your postseason.
Well, and we saw a situation, too, tonight with this Bears team. Earlier kind of mentioned, if you listen to the halftime interview with Camden Cox, he talked about the fact how we went from these vocal leaders that were on the team last year, from a Cam Cardwell, a Gabe Bowling, and these different players that, graduated and moved on. And now you had a team this year that had different leadership that might not be as vocal, but still searching for an identity. And I think they kind of found that tonight a little bit. You found that with leaders like Keenan Carnes and Nick Stowe and Danny Armstrong and Kellen Marksberry and what they were able to do on the field. It's not so much that they were that vocal leadership that you get from like a Cam Cardwell, leading by example out there, not giving up, playing that great defense. Offensively, we mentioned quite a few times the names Tanner Schuler, Connor Lawson, being able to get the blocks that they got on the offensive line. And again, leading by example, showing these younger kids how to play the game, getting excited for it, making great plays. And it's a Spencer County football team that, other than a few miscues, really kind of put a lot of things together in this game to have a complete football game that they were able to come away with the victors.
Yeah, go ahead, Phillips. Malachi Sage. Sage. Parents need to find him. He's a 5-year-old kid running around here somewhere, folks.
Yeah, keep your eyes open.
Keep your eyes open. blue Spider-Man shirt if anybody sees him. So, John, well, going to end right quick with some scores. The games that we picked tonight, Collins and Oldham County. Collins is currently up 24-0 in that game. The Scott County-Boyle County game, battle of number ones in the state between 5A and 4A. Boyle County leads Scott County 54-21 late in that game. And the battle of quarterbacks over here at Christian Academy, Lexington Christian leads Cal 14-12. That game also late in the fourth quarter.
Now, I want to point something out. Of course, last week I was 3-1 with my picks. We already know that I've got the Collins game. We got this game here. We got the Boyle County game. So really down to the Lexington Christian Cal, I could go 4-0 this week, Bo. I just want to make sure everybody knows that you got to listen to the old expert up here, Big John, as he gives you his takes on the games in the local area.
Hey, you know, there is sports gambling now in Kentucky.
There is. But
I don't think it's legal on high school sports.
I'm trying to remain as humble as I can, you know, make sure everybody knows that I'm trying to use my expertise and go from there. I'm being threatened to be muted in my headset right now, so we're going to settle it down. I think, Bo, I don't have anything else for this game. And
next Friday night, about 6:30, 6:40, we'll come on the air. We'll be at Franklin County.
That's
if you
right.
can't make the trip down to Frankfort for the game, join us here on GHP Sports. Go to that YouTube page, folks. Subscribe to the channel.
Please.
We creeped over 900 this week, and we're trying to get to 1,000. So help us out there. And so, John, your final score tonight, Spencer County 19, Fairdale 15. We'll see you next Friday night on GHP Sports.